Karen Macdonald grew up in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, where she studied interior decorating at University of Saskatchewan in 1982, where she was Miss Saskatoon runner-up the same year. She then attended Kelsey Technical College of Nursing, becoming a registered nurse in 1987, and was the nurses' union representative of Royal University Hospital, neonatal postpartum from 1987 to 2001. She then passionately pursued the freedom and peace for the protection of children in courts from 1987 to present, focused on mind control MK Ultra and the unlawful abductions of tribal, clan, and international Star Nation children. She is the head matriarch of the White Bear Star Nations. She is an advocate for the removal of vaccines and smart meters, among many others. Her training includes biowarfare, herbology, aromatherapy, massage, Vita reflexology, sclera iridology, kinesiology, matrix energy medicine, reiki, prana yoga, heirloom gardening, shaman, alchemy, and crystal spring water protection. She is currently researching and developing antidotes on a simple iPhone, iPad, tablet app called the Genius Insight Biofeedback, using sound and biophotonic scalar rife and somatic solfeggio frequencies as a pulsed electronic magnetic radio wave PEMF therapy. Welcome to the Nexus, Karen. It's nice to have you today.
Thank you for your kind invitation, Robert. I'm so excited to be here.
Well, I've been looking forward to this since we first connected back around the beginning of the year.
Yeah, it was a start for a new year, wasn't it?
It was quite the start.
Not on our calendar, but on someone's. It was a nice beginning for anyway.
It was quite the interesting cadre of characters, if you will, that we met each other on. And it was fascinating because of all the different characters that were in that group, there was something about the conversations that you were having with them and that I was having with them that we recognized that I think we need to have a conversation together.
We did for hours.
A nonstop, ongoing conversation of all things very fascinating, interesting, and I think most importantly, something that is not only important for today, but I think is going to be extremely important for the future. And that is looking at natural healing techniques and traditions and modern modalities. Because I'm seeing, and I think this is actually happening across just about all the domains that we are collectively as well as individually going through, which is a blend of the old and the new, or what would be considered the old. And I know that when I became a shiatsu practitioner back in the 80s, one of the things that I learned was that the allopathic approach, which is traditionally our Western methods and models of medicine, was missing a whole bunch of things. And not only from the standpoint of the way that health and wellness was approached, but it was missing all of these ancient ways and knowledge and understanding that have been around healing the ancestors, our ancestors, but as Tom and I talked about, us being ancestors in training for the future. And as I learned traditional Chinese medicine and kinesiology and herbology and all of the different types of massage techniques, I started to realize that there was a much different way of approaching health that was available that had been around and tested, time-tested, empirical evidence, data that shows that these things that have been healing humans, healing these Homo sapien carbon-based meat suits that we inhabit, have been around for millennia. And apparently there was something that was effective in those treatments and those approaches because we survived, we're here. But now we see essentially the new epidemic that's been rising for the last couple of decades, which is all of these anomalous health problems that people are having. Everything from the physical to the mental and the spiritual. And all of those things can be addressed in a much more effective and natural way by looking at the ancient traditions and techniques for healing. At the same time, there's some amazing modern modalities that are coming out on the scene, which we'll talk about in this conversation. One of them being the Genius app that you're working with. And I'm very excited for you to explain that and share what that is for the audience, because I think that it's one of the profound ways in which sound and light, vibration and frequency are going to transform not only the physical and mental health of people, but the future of how we engage with the environment that we're in. So let's start with some of the your experience and knowledge in some of the ancient, what are considered ancient, ways of healing and health and wellness. I know you've done a lot of work with oils, a lot of work with energies and so forth. So I'd like your view on what I just talked about as far as these ancient ways of healing and health, and what's your overall view of it, and what are the ones that you have found most effective?
With my background growing up, this is an ethnic thing. It's like, you know, the Bedrus, right? The Russian. But my babas and stuff like that, when I was growing up, there was very much a focus on natural healing. It was a combination I started seeing, I guess, right, really with my baba and a music in Saskatoon. And when I grew up, we had the gardens with raspberry patches. We did canning. We did prepping. That was what we did. And my Gita, Peter Buzik, was actually part of the military, the army. And so that was the first thing they started kind of training, like, you know, getting the basics into what we need to grow up with to live and thrive rather than survive. And I see what happened in there. She was actually one of the first victims of when they started bringing cobalt in. So a lot of people don't realize when I grew up out of Saskatoon by the University of Saskatchewan, it's one of the biggest test centers for not only Vito, you know, which is your injection headquarters. It's the CERN synchrotron light source. There's a lot of things, eugenics, forensic psychiatry, all sorts of things it's known for. A Draco, I would call the Royal Royal University Hospital there, that I was a nurse and I worked for, you know, I've been 40 years nursing right now as a nurse, but I've gone holistic. So when it was instilled into me what I saw, and she was one of the first victims of the cobalt, which is what, you know, is chemo and radiation for things like arthritis. And yet they had the garlic pills and they had the garden, but, you know, there was basics still missing. But that I could see that generation now in retrospect, where it became, you know, walking in both worlds. And then it became the pills. And then my mother ended up as well, Eleanor Buzik, and she married Glenn Macdonald. And I'm the eldest of four siblings. I've got three other siblings. And so I was very different. They all sort of seemed to go into this allopathic thing into this day. Like, you know, my sister's one of the people in MD ambulance and stuff like that. And they're on the ejection team. And it's everything that I'm against, you know, everything in here. And so I think there's something, and maybe it's something incumbent in part of us. And then I'm also, because of the oldest, and I was also raised as a clan mother. So I'm the carrier, supposedly, the wisdom, supposedly, the knowledge, the wisdom, all those kind of original customs, usages, and laws. And that's what defines a tribe, a clan, or a nation to this day. And today we still supersede anything foreign, domestic, or lower corpus juris secundum, you know, or Kamala, admiralty, maritime. Okay, so we're the ones that put in for, you know, international warrants for crimes against humanity and acts of war and treason, actually. And that ties into how we see things. Do we see things in legalese? Do we see it in law? Do we see it in naturopathy, or do we see it in allopathics? And from that, when you see the allopathic end of it, you're seeing the iretrogenetics, which is medically induced murder, basically. You know, and up here in these areas, you know, we're so have such an abundance of flowers and natural herbs and spring waters and hot springs and stuff. We should be at the top of the game. This should be, you know, the Garden of Eden, really, for us. And yet we see how it's been, industrialized, nuclear facilities, tar sands, people thrown into bands and reserves like prisoners of war, which is really what it is. They're a third world class citizen, and so is Canada, States, and everything else. They're not even a second world country. They're like a third class citizen. And now that
So
they're all bankrupt. So it ties into the medicine part too.
it sounds like the history of what you were raised with goes back millennia. It
Yes.
it's a it's it's ancient wisdom,
Original wisdom, yeah.
and based on natural law.
It is the law. We are the law.
And I think that's one of the things that has been completely. That natural law has been suppressed. It's been replaced. And what I'm seeing is a great deal of, I think the ailments that people are experiencing is a result of not only, and this is what I learned when I was became a shiatsu practitioner and got into traditional Chinese medicine. The treating of the symptom as opposed to the problem
Cause.
is where this whole allopathic diverged, and it went off. Okay, well, we're just going to try to treat the symptom. We're not going to be looking necessarily at what is the cause, what's the reason for the ailment. And 100 years ago we were all preppers, right?
Well, we
Everybody
still
was
are. We live like that. We should be doing that. And it, I think it's more of, preparing for the worst and hoping for the best. I have lots of things we may never use, but doesn't mean I don't have the backup here just in case. I have a solar panel just in case. I have a generator just in case. I have candles just in case. I choose, obviously natural stuff and eco-friendly versus, necessarily always beeswax and like, paraffin. But that becomes how we define who we are. And there, whether it's law or it's herbs or it's oils, there's always like a heavenly or celestial type of law, and or intergalactic or star seed law. Star, that's what they call the star chambers, by the way. And in here, what happened is that you would have basically what would be hereditaries, or we would call therapeutic. The Essenes would say it's, essential, but it's the essential therapeutic thera. To be healing. And then your second class, which would be what we would call organics, which anyone can go into the store and get a food. It's got a number 9 on the sticker. Most people can't read labels. Okay. Which means the seed's still, again, there's some stuff in here, but there may be some industrial, and we all agree there's contamination everywhere. Food, water, people, off-gassing, whatever. But when you get into the other thing, and in law, that would be what you would call private public. Where they try to pitch left and right. So that's what they call, and as I talk to a lawyer, corpus juris secundum, CJS. They all have it. A lawyer will know what I'm talking about. That means you're dead to the letter of the law, and that's what they train every judge and lawyer, sheriff, provost, marshal, all of them in here. So this is what they're playing with all these people trying to be state nationals. Or I gotta make a life claim, I gotta go do this, right? Because they're lost souls. They don't know who they are. They've lost the lineage of tracing their roots. And that's why it's really important. That's why I even introduce myself. Who are you? Where do you come from? I'm from the creator. I'm a soul. I knew that very early when I was 3 years old. I was apparently telling them all. I was a nurse. I came through the sun, through the soul gate.
So
Okay.
talk about that a little bit more about the genetic component, the DNA that we are from a hereditary perspective,
Yes.
that we are composed of subatomics, atoms, molecules, all of the chemicals and the chemical reactions that make up our biological component. But the influence to that, what is your experience and knowledge about how that actually is in its original state, but also how it has been affected? What are the influences that have changed that?
I could be here forever on that. I see that, and again, being a former neonatal intensive care, you see children, you see the damage because the parents aren't looking after, or because of the incompatibility. We used to all go, that's some sort of genetic inbreeding. They shouldn't have done that. That's what I used to say back then, and I still say it today, even more so. Now we see what's happening with the transgender. We see what's happening with lots of things that they're playing with genetics that they shouldn't have been. And we see what happened with, especially with the HPV. A lot of our children were subjected to that about 10, 15 years ago. Now we're seeing that entire thing that, they all want to be transforming male to female. It's turning them into, it's not even into the other genders. It's putting that other genders in to override it like a program to become basically an Enoch. You're basically like the Baphomet, right? And what it is it's designed to take out not only male and female, it's designed so that the bloodline is taken out. And so this whole thing with the injections came into something called, I don't know if you're aware of the word telogeny. And telogeny is one of my favorite words, okay? And it's taught in a set of books. I don't know, have you ever heard of the books? They're called The Ringing Cedars of Russia. Okay, fascinating set of books. That's why I sit in front of the bookshelf here. Okay, this is a set of books. Now they got all sort of cute little black and white magnolia things, but these are the original traditional books. Anastasia was basically talking about telogeny, ETs, original laws, customs for all of us. And this is about going back. It's actually done like if A is 1, B is 2, and C is 3. It's done in basically a mathematical code. But it talks about the original laws pre-flood, what you would call Tartarian. And the Ved Rus could be, and it's too bad my PowerPoint didn't work today, but we will take a look at some of that. But the Tartarian or Arcturian, or what some people call White Bear Clan, see the little white bear up there? Bear Arcturian or Ursuline. So my blood type is AB positive. And that AB positive translates, Alex Collier would say, hey, they're from Ursa Minor. Guess what? They're the Arcturians. So there's a domination of Arcturians, and there's so much we are made so much of, not just stardust, star seed, quantum dots, and quantum maybe seeds and dust these days too. But I mean, at the end, we're a mixture, a compilation, a beautiful smorgasbord of a lot of galactic genetics. And some people will say we're up to 24 different races. Okay, and I did a lot of stuff at Project Ascension, and I spoke a lot about genetics, who are we, where do we come from, how does this fit in? How were the progenitors here? How did we start? Was it Enki, Enlil, and then her hag? Could be a lot of things. Like the old hags were known as the clan mothers. So the hag court was the original, the old women. So a lot of people, they think it's quite funny. They always think when they say, well, clan mother Karen's coming, right? Or mother Karen's coming. And they expect someone with like a little cane and like, white all hair. Not me sitting around going, okay, let's go do something. Right? Because it's about being back in touch with yourself. And when you lose touch with the plants and you go into the allopathics, and I know that. Look at what's happening today. You see people that are not alkaline, they're using artificial semi-synthetics. Then you have people even all out on the rosters right now. I can put a whole bunch of them, the top 10 or the top 5 docs and stuff. And even though they're trying to present some stuff, they're all presenting back a medical model to you. Here, have some nicotine patches. Have some ivermectin, right? Made from the same company, from BlackRock, Merrick, Umbrella, Mobius, right? All the military industrial complexes, right? And they want you to put your energy in and use that same DNA. And when you know about how everything's connected in the quantum field, the quantum entanglement, do you really think I want to have oral sex with Mr. Merrick and Monsanto and Bill Gates if when they were here? No. Why would you put that stuff in there or up your, whatever rectum? Yeah. And I'm a colon hydrotherapist. So what's a natural version of it? Like, this is where I get into talking to people. You want tobacco? I have lots of tobacco. It's called Hopi sacred tobacco. Some people like to smudge and burn with it. Some people like to do a lot of things, but I've kind of upgraded a little bit from this to, then you can move all of these plants into herbs and oils, and then you could take tobacco. That's actually what tobacco looks like here. Ground up. I don't know if you can see. Quite dark here. But that tobacco in here is thick. And why would I not take the tobacco rather than putting on semi-synthetic patches and drugs that are known carcinogens and cause cancer? Because some doctor's up there telling you that's on the mainstream media. And not only did people, I see this, it's like, they pitched the allopathic with the natural, right? And we have something called integrative medicine. It's called complementary alternative medicine. And I got very much into that. And mine, like anything, I had two wonderful children. And that's the whole thing when you learn also about law versus legalese and how we get targeted because of the mtDNA, because of that knowledge, because they want our DNA. And if they can't corrupt us or civilize us, right? We're actually in law. When I talked about the celestial, we're known as savages. So I'm actually a little savage. It's not a derogatory term, right? And neither is a quack or a whack. I mean, a quack was actually a naturopath doctor that used to use those herbs and oils like a little duck's bill, right? I always wanted to be on Quack Watch. I said, if I could be up there with like Dr. Len Horowitz, I worked with, the Dr. Gary Young, all my favorite mentors in this world were on there. I was like, I haven't gotten there yet. Right? Dr. Robert Young, right? And when we have that original thoughts and bring something forth from our genetic line, like at one point, my mom went, or my baba went from getting organic beef, like heirloom beef to actually, right? And then they'd boil up and make borscht or, pickled whatever you want, pickled beets and stuff and relish and stuff. And then I went, when I learned my stuff, I took it one step further because my mom started getting like, Mackenzie in the garden. I was like, well, just wait, that's not healthy. You can't read the label, Mom. But I saw that what how her generation got corrupted and on medicines and got addicted. And my mom would, spent a year studying to be a psych nurse in one of the biggest famous hospitals up here, North Belford Psychiatric, where they did a lot of like, lobotomies. They did ECT, shock therapies. They did everything for MK Ultra here up there. And I mean, I've been in those facilities as well, because when you stand up as a naturopath or stand up in the courts, then they want to take you down or they're going to test you, So, Dr. Robert Young and I have a lot in common because I've had the SWAT team surround my clinics back then while I was doing colonics with people. It was the best time to show up, but, we're 11 o'clock at night without warrants. But they want to shut you down or they want to learn what they can off of you. And make no mistake, they do know the law at the highest echelon. So when we, I think a lot of people say, oh, well, they don't know what they're doing or best intents. Intents, good intentions pave the way to hell. And I mean, those were the nurses and the doctors and everything else that were involved in this entire, I heard you say it too, plandemic, scandemic, right? It's fungicide, it's herbicide, it's, a genocide, a democide, a tribal side, a woman's side, a child's side, and a man's side. Everything that they did was to wipe out that genetic line. And so at Project Ascension, I spent some time with Patrick Brassard, Andrew Mallett, Sergeant Daniel Brad McMullen, and some of the other brightest people I could get back in 2016. And every week we had our own shows and radio shows and all sorts of podcasts. And what we're doing now is what I was doing actually 10 years ago. And but bringing things in here, and when you learn about the genetic lines of how that's what they're targeting, that's what they sell on and off the planet. And I did some really great shows with a friend of mine just passed away, Larry Levan. He was just amazing in his 80s, again of vaccine injury, right? But trying to assist him in the last 4 months of his life, we did phenomenal stuff because he was a former Navy court-martial lawyer called a JAG, very special. Elite class of the judge advocate generals. So for 4 months, we went at it hardcore. We were looking at pre-flood treaties, and there are pre-flood treaties that govern this planet to this day. And these are the ones that I've put forward into all the different international forces, international courts, and they've all been put on notice. We have things from our lineage, for example, all the different people you would say. White tribal. We're not white race. We're not Rh negative. We're white tribal. We're Rh positive. And so that is an original tie to Gaia's bloodline. We have terrarian blood. And some are what you call old souls, or we're the new souls on the block. But in here, that's very important that you need to know that. And I'll just take it one step further. We have international treaties. Galactics had treaties up there. They're children had them here. And so mine is the Noah's Arcturian line. There might be the Palladian, Palladior Troy, Solomon Seal. Most people have heard of wampum belts, or we're going to smoke the peace pipe treaties, canes of authority. But they also called it the Eagle Bull or the Kamadic language. Very, very important when you learn about the Kamadic languages and the Eagle Bull. So those exist to this day. And that is the law of the land. And that's what I want them to enforce.
Okay, so there's a lot to unpack there.
Sure. Go with you. We always do.
So from the genetic component perspective, there's a lot going on there, which you just gave a quick summary of. When it comes to healing modalities for those different genetic lines, is there anything or a set of common approaches and treatments and techniques that are common across all these different genetic lines? Or is it very, can it get, does it get very specific depending on the genetics that you have that has come through the bloodline, through the genealogy that, for example, for me, of course, I'm one of those wacko woo-woo hybrid wanderers, and I've never done a genetic test, but I'm told that, I've got English, Irish, and German from our current models. But I also feel like I got something else going on in there that is deeper and more foundational. I don't know what it is. But when those different genetic lines have to deal with ailments, and healing and health and wellness, is there a common set across the different bloodlines and different genetic species that are out there?
Yeah, actually, there is. It's an excellent question. It goes back to what I was talking about with Anastasia, with the ringing cedars, the rush of the telegony, and also who you've been with. Okay, there's a thing about the virginity, and that's not what, wasn't, they didn't intercourse. It's the DNA and the purity of the line. Whether you want to call us high priestesses or shamans or shamanists, whatever you like, medicine women. But what happened is that those bloodlines, the more they integrate or disintegrate, depending who they've been intercoursing or mating with, is very important. And you're seeing that now with the injections, because people are now realizing that whoever you sleep with, even though you didn't take the injection, that you're now deemed homo hyborgenesis. You've been mutated. And you now get what's called contagious contact vaccinosis, which means you've been in contact with someone and you've picked up the same thing, that you're developing the same symptoms. And for example, for me, the cleaner the bloodlines are, the more reactive you are. We're kind of like the canaries in the coal mine, so to speak. So it's not that we're hypersensitive, it's just our immune system functions. And so, for example, if I'm near anyone vaxxed or PCR'd or something like that, because they're so radioactive and there's such toxic elements coming off of them, but they literally are radiating because they've been hooked up to the, Internet of Things. They're basically like walking 5G, 6G towers. And I will start vaginally bleeding right within an hour. And there's nothing wrong with me. It's what's wrong with that environment. So having said that, what's the common thread for all of us? One of the incredible people I met along my journey was David Wolf. Other people were Dr. Gabriel Cousins, MD, and he wrote an entire set of books called Rainbow Cuisine and Conscious Eating and Kitchen. But he was an MD that went into the naturopathy and set up in Arizona, actually, the Tree Life Rejuvenation Center. But what he was first able to debunk was all the eat right for your blood type. And it's the same thing. That's why they had back in telegony. The short version of it is that if you had, let's say, we'll make it, anyone that's doing pedigrees for dogs or does breeding will know what I'm talking about. Horses, dogs, the whole thing, But what it does is that let's say you had a white female and she slept with a black male dog. Okay, so the dogs, and then she went and started still sleeping with white dogs after that. So people would think the father would be white, they should both be white. But what happens is a lot of the puppies then, the children, could be black. And what happens is that the strongest male or female, whoever you sleep with, the first intercourse you have is the strongest, most dominant DNA as well. And that's why we know that on autopsy, you can find the energy signatures of all the men that they slept with. So basically, you've got a residual trace of sperm of every guy, and the same thing. So this is why getting into teaching back, who did you sleep with? Who did you intercourse? What was the difference of courting versus dating? So you're not that much older, a little bit older than I am, but you would remember. Can I rub that in? No.
Oh, yeah. Go right ahead. Oh, okay. I wear it proudly.
Okay. But even I remember the stories of you couldn't get married, especially in the States or different things in Scotland, stuff like that, even back to the 60s, 50s and 60s, until you had a blood test. They wouldn't let you marry. And that's why a lot of people eloped and they started, you know, doing, you know, out of state stuff, right? Or they all went to Vegas because you didn't need a blood test. Because even till then, not that long ago, still in our generation, is that you had to have your blood typing done. And you weren't supposed to intercourse with your own. And you weren't supposed to ever mate an Rh positive with an Rh negative. Okay? And there are people very much in the secret space program that say the Rh negatives, again, are galactic or have galactic stuff. And there were treaties into place. Come down here, non-interference, and that didn't mean coming in and stealing and mating with the women. We saw things that happened with President Eisenhower and other things, Majestic 12 and all these sort of nefarious things, and Project Paperclip and Project High Jump and blah, 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 blah. All the stuff that we see subsequently from, you know, the 30s, 40s, and 50s primarily, that they started actually selling people and genetics. And they do. That's what your entire banking system was built on. Trust funds back to the Vatican, back to the, you know, anywhere 900s, 1200s, you know, Saskatoon trust funds and stuff like this that we are now actually dissolving. So that's part of things that I'm involved with as well. And how it ties into the genetics, even when we had like, and I was going to show you my, which I can't, we can go to, you know, my Facebook. I have a thing right up there. There's a whole thing. Who am I? Who do I come off of? What's my lineage? Right? You know, so that's why when I present myself, right, it's technically your grace. Karen Ann, and on my matriarchal side is Lutzik, Zatchuk, in that realm. On my patriarchal side is Macdonalds, Mackenzies, and Barons, right? And all of us had tartans, coat of arms. Remember when they talk about bear your arms,
mm-hmm.
right? Or she's a little tart.
Yeah.
Don't get out of kilter, right?
Right.
Get out of kilter. Okay, those are all valid sayings. So we would look at, you know, here the tartans, and well, you don't want to sleep with, she's your cousin. Like, you don't want to do that. And that's what the clan mothers did. You can look up clan mothers, and I always use K because I use the original Kemetic Lang, and that's my lineage. I'm not one of the Illuminati clan mothers. And nor am I part of Kanata, nor am I part of the KKK. Because those imperial orders that were from the Draco Reptilian groups came here and set up their own clan mothers and their own Illuminati system and their own Illuminati 13 bloodlines. But guess what? We had our original 12 tribes, 12 clans, and 12 nations. And so it's the 13th clan mother. I'm the head matriarch, right? And what it means is that this is not a corporation for 65%. You do not have shares in the corporation. You don't have to buy your way into a nation or a clan or anything, it's your bloodline. And it comes simply through, who did you come through? Your mother. Now, we can agree and talk about implants and my labs and all sorts of things and in vitro. But for the most part, it's the mother's, and it's called a mitochondrial DNA. So mine could be traced back thousands and tens of thousands of years. So we have those seals, we have those things on plate in stone, records, obelisks that go back thousands of years. So I really don't care about the Canadian or the American flag. And I don't care which version of it. I don't care if it's up, down, fringed, not in distress. It doesn't matter. The bottom line is that they're all war flags. And they're not your mother's lineage. They're not your flags.
Okay, so there's a whole nother can of worms that you've opened up there. So let me pull one out and tug on it a minute. You've heard my version of reality in my Informatica philosophy,
yep.
And that's based on consciousness, which is creates the entire, is the reason of the reality that we inhabit. And the characteristics of that consciousness is constant motion, and it unfolds constantly as creation. And that is done through energy. Energy being the fuel, the essence, if you will, of consciousness. And that energy is expressed through an infinite field of frequencies.
Yeah.
And those frequencies then create the material realm and the ethereal realm, both the ethereum and the materium, from the physics to the metaphysics and everything in between.
Yep.
And it creates the reality we inhabit. Now, in order, and this is where I'm going to go with this question. In order for us to have this reality and have the unique individual expression of our individuality, we are the result of this energy expressing itself through frequencies. And we are individual, unique frequency stamps of the energy, which is from consciousness. So that individual, unique expression is something that once it pops in from this constant motion of creation from the energy of consciousness, then it becomes a frequency stamp, a signature. And it exists forever in this infinite field of frequencies. Now, how it manifests, how it individually floats and engages with the cycles within the infinite frequency fields is what we are currently expressed as in our carbon-based biological material meat suit that we inhabit.
Wait, you can say, I was going to go,
he's going to say meat suit.
Yeah, the avatar. Yep.
So my question is this. The genetics are a component of the materium, of the biology that we inhabit here.
Yeah.
The unique frequency stamp of frequencies that we are is separate from that. It inhabits this biology, but it is also unique and separate from it. It doesn't require the biology and the materium to exist in. It simply comes in essentially, it ubers, if you will, our biology in the materium that we inhabit. So my question is this. How much of the unique frequency stamp, if indeed what I'm suggesting and putting forth is true, which I think it is, because I don't care which domain of science and knowledge you go down, they all, half of what's in there is questionable. The other half is either missing or discarded or dismissed. But when you look at the basic functionality of the way that reality functions, the way that consciousness works, the speculation is more than plentiful of the why and the how. But the what is, it's hard to argue the fact that this is the way it works. So that's what my Informatica model is how does everything function? The why is going to be open for endless speculation, and it's been that way for millennia since we've had anything that people have observed and speculated on their own. But nonetheless, we are energy. Even quantum theory and mechanics and all that says that everything is energy. Everything's in a constant motion. It's constantly waving. They're finally getting away from the billiard ball model, the grit model, because they're realizing that nothing is solid. Everything is fluid energy.
Yep.
How can that affect the genetics in our biology?
Huge. Look what just happened in the last little while, right? I mean, we have like a physical avatar, but we also have that soul or that energy, whether people want to look at chakras, or a friend of mine, Sabrina Wallace, right, talks about the incredible biofield, or you hear, you know, like David Sarita or Dan Willis, some of the other people I know, Dan Winters, you're talking about this incredible field, and it's actually out here, you know, before, like you said, it's whether you think it comes this way, out through the chakras, however it is, we have a little Merkaba or a little bubble around us, and that's actually why I've concentrated on there. Our genetics plays a huge role on that, because they can, and I'll use the proverbial A, because there's an A, there's a deep, whether it's the AI that's the military-industrial complexes, they are targeting people for genetics. And they can do that very easily. You know, you are seeing what they've done with the hormones. Now they're targeting children. They're targeting like actual gender, which is amazing, let alone like just, you know, we want to take out this race or that race or whatever. But in here, having said that, there are things that we share in common. And there are people like I've done some amazing stuff with one Dr. Robert Young, but is Dr. Robert Morse. And he's an amazing shaman, but he's one of the top naturopath doctors. Getting back to like what Dr. Sevi did, let's go back to eating tribally. How our people ate. So, for example, in this day and age, people are all talking about, well, maybe there's some out of space like mushrooms that came in. Showing up anywhere. It's got a mycelium, you know, network everywhere. You know, this is gonna work.
Well, they even
And
have that on the latest Star Trek series called Discovery. The ship has, they found this thing called a mycelium drive, and they're able to jump the mycelium network throughout time and space and just instantly go from here to there. And when I first heard about that, I said, now there's something I'd like to know more about because it actually sounds plausible. But back to the question about can the energetic frequency stamp that we are from this field of consciousness and energy, can we use that if we're aware of it
yes.
to fix, repair, even alter the genetic stuff that we've either gotten through a heredity or more importantly, through the bombardment of bullshit that everybody is getting through food and through the air and through water and the pharmaceuticals, everything else that's being, in my opinion, purposely designed or mangled and manipulated to really screw with the DNA. But can we affect and use our consciousness and that energy as a part of the healing modalities?
Absolutely. One of my favorite mentors I ever learned from was, I don't know if you know of him, is Dr. Richard Bartlett. He wrote Matrix Energetics and the Physics of Miracles, actually. And also Dr. Gary Young. But it was the concept when I was taught how to do firewalking, whether you went skydiving, scuba diving, or firewalking. It's mind is the matter. And when you get into the stuff, what we're talking about, like Dr. Paul Durand, who runs our Quantum Integrative University, which Ryan Williams has taught at. And I was actually asked to be a professor of many years ago. And then I decided, no, we need to land and to protect children and water. I had a different thing. But that idea of epigenetics that Bruce Lipton talks about, or, you know, you get into the whole thing with the holomeres, or you see people, and you can Google this because that's why I'm not trying to be facetious dropping names. These are actually usually colleagues of mine that I actually know. And when you look at, there's a great video. It's only about 3 minutes long, but you see actually Greg Braden. And he's sitting there with a bunch of monks and they start chanting, Wasa, Wasa, which is, it's done. It's happened. You know, thank you. It's occurred already. But they start just doing the chant. But if you get people that are higher vibrational around someone that's lower, right? Or you get the women all starting to menstruate or the pendulums all starting to swing, whatever. But they started putting in different tones, and those tones act like ultrasound, which is getting back to the frequency. And we actually watched a bladder tumor dissolve within minutes. And there's my other favorite thing that I used to teach when I used to go out for the Quantum Alliance and teach biofeedback for all the Western Canada. And I was one of the Western Canadian reps for all the health expos out here for about a decade. And so we would go out there and we would use the sound waves and the scalar waves. So whether we used ultrasound in the hospital to get rid of, you know, a kidney stone, well, you know, we measured you with EEGs and AKGs, and we were putting Holter monitors and leads and patches and all sorts of things. We thought we knew what we were doing, but we really didn't. Not when you look at what we could do. And if you heal the soul, the spirit first, that you realize that you are have a divine blueprint. And this is even where people start talking about sovereignty. You don't want to be on the level of a sovereign that we're about to arrest because they're illegal aliens without treaties here, right? But when you realize who you are and where you come from and those original laws, your creator's laws translates into anything that you eat, touch, see, feel, put into your entire avatar. Okay? And when we can take frequencies and sound or biophotonic lights, biomodulation, we can actually start repairing that. And I have shown that with Dr. Robert Young on some of the shows and with Ryan Williams at Genius Insight Health Apps. Recently, I've just done some stuff with my friend down the road, Janine Strong, who's got Keeping It Real with Janine. That was our chicken story. But what we did is we actually brought in people that do live blood. And so what we did is I would do these. I don't need a month. I can actually do a therapy, and within minutes, your system will respond positively, neutrally, or negatively. And I could see that using sound and primarily water, my background is water. I'm like David Wolf with findaspring.com. It's about biophotonic, ormus-rich, non-radiated, non-bastardized water. It's pure virgin. It's the living waters, and they talk about it even scripturally. And when you get those waters and back to one cell, or when you think about when male and female come together and they make a child, right? And you use those incredible energies together, what comes out is a drop of blood. That's why I focus on the live blood cell analysis, but also with the water technology. And in here, there are many things we have used. My genetics, okay? Aside from stuff, people have heard of shaga mushrooms. In our language, we call it tashaga, by the way. Potato, potato. That's okay. Mm-hmm. But what happens, there are many things that work for almost all of us. And that's actually why I got into the biofeedback industry. Way back when, I mean, I had my children. I was then doing health centers because I discovered very early after a back injury that there was no way I could go back to that field. But while I was there, I was exploring everything. So while I got injured with my two young children at home, and I couldn't move off basically the couch or the bed after surgery, is that everything became a game. I was like, I got to look at something else. And I then became a Reiki master. I studied sclerology, iridology, herbology. I went to meet with Gary Young. I learned not only, because I said to firewalk, but I learned everything I could about oils and frequency, because he was one of the first people teaching frequency, him and Dr. David Stewart. And, you know, I trained with them. And when you see that, you know, whoa, wow. And this is, I'd like the audience, if they haven't looked at this, right? I did stuff with Stephen Day Kelly years ago, learning about scalar wave. And when you start getting into the, again, weaponry part of it, like what Lieutenant Colonel Tom Bearden talks about, or other people that you'll hear in the Secret Space Program, or Kerry Cassidy, or I just did one with Nancy Hopkins, Derek Conduit, and those guys, Walt Silva, Mark Joseph, because they're the people that are with the direct energy weapons. And as we talked about the mushrooms coming in, another thing that we're playing with right now is a very rare form of shungite that comes from a very specific thing in Russia that they've given me to play with. And we're putting shungite into different areas, just like you would have the mycelium. And we're creating a shungite thing because it's off planet and has a different frequency and a different aura. So these are things that could be used for all people in here. And there are people that are hybridized, like you said, or Heinz 57 or tribrids or whatever, not just in human between human, but between races. Okay, so what I'm trying to do, and that's why I find things, what's a universal healer? Water. And to me, that's where I focus with the genus biofeedback, because the solution to this pollution is dilution. And so I can see it very clearly, like on here. And that's why, you know, I think it's when we start going into things like nano silvers, carbon C60s, fullerenes 70s, these type of things, silvers at 20,000 parts per million, you know, or you get into the zeolites at that high concentration, they start being able to, and this is what they've been trying to do, is get past our blood-brain barrier. The trees do it naturally. So I have no problem using frankincense and myrrh and sandalwood and cedarwood and myrrh and spruce and just marinating everyone, right? There's nothing like being in the forest here, you know, which, you know, if I opened up that curtain, you just see the whole forest here. But what happens is that you get the synthetics. And when you start also putting in metallic things like that, at that sort of subatomic little particles, and so micromesh that they can get up into here, they can also act as what's called an attractant. And as we're applying, this is where I'm going to bring this into doing like the matrix, is what's sitting out here is now got an effect on us. So that cell phone tower at 5G, 6G, or now every street light is weaponized. Your smart meter is weaponized. Your water meter has been weaponized out here. we have to protect ourselves, and that's the one thing that I'm very intent on. So it could be something very simple, like putting copper in and around you, a wire. That's why we're doing electrical culture around all our plants up here. They're the only thing that's going to probably live up here. We just found out that 95% of our forest and our orchards and our fruit trees, 95% of the fruit trees are dead here. Right? Not only through the weather geoengineering, shocking, but also to do with the advancement of 6, 7, 8, 9G up here, which, of course, no one's talking about. You know, they're still on 5G, and that's like last decade. That's the old news. So I've been doing a lot of shows with people. I met with Brian Pelche. I've met with people like Eric Fire Medic or Elena Freeland the other day, but I really got into stuff with Tony Pantelresco. I think Tony's an absolute on to a lot of stuff like this, because these people have been so afflicted with things like Morgellon and Lyme, and you know, this parasitical component is really what the large part of what people are saying, diabetes, cancers, depression, anxiety, that type of thing, hormonal imbalances. And so if we can use these frequencies, and in a simple term, every plant's got a frequency. For example, peppermint is at 76 hertz, right? And then you get into spruce, which is 560. If you take anything off there, and for example, these plants that I have out here, they don't go beyond 20, 30 hertz. And that's why it's really important people look at the frequency of the food. It's not about, you know, and again, the more you put a semi-synthetic, you're not getting a pure connection. No. It's like putting something between you and the creator. You know, I don't need a priest to go talk to the creator, for crap's sake. Why would I put something like as a third party intercessory, which is the same thing you see in tribal laws, right? That's why no one would ever get wedded and get with a certificate. And again, you contract not only the male but the female, but the product of that union becomes property of the state, which is we're trying to so educate people. And this is why this all ties together what natural law is. You can't just isolate it. It's our food, it's our water. That's why I go get spring water. I wouldn't get something from the tap from a village or a city that's you know, think they own it and put through all this artificial stuff. No, because I think what it comes down to, I think in the essence, Robert, is love. And it's not about loving other people, it's loving yourself. You can't love anyone else till you love yourself. And even that, then there's peace, then there's creation, then there's co-creation, and then there's that one with the whatever metaverse, whatever you want to call it. You know, we were talking about words and the whole linguistics of it. And the thing that people spell with, you know, I said to people, if I said, hey, hey, ho, Yahweh, hey, yo, Manitoumaqua, Manitoumaqua, and people are going like, what the flip did she say? Other than maybe, you know, 1% of the population here, because that's the national anthem. That's the language. That's some of the law stuff. Those are our tribes. And it was interesting up in here. I'm very close to the Samaics. You know, they're in pit houses right now. Their matriarchs have been living in the underground, you know, sunk root cellars, whatever you want to call it, but they got a pit house. I've been in there. I've done ceremonies. I've danced on the solstices with the chiefs. And that is put into protection. They know what's coming up for the prophecy, for the end times, for the apocalypse. Or again, we're just switching from, you know, grade 3 to grade 4 to grade 5, and just depending where you want to go. But they know about this stuff. It's been passed down. And those are some of the things I have. And I mean, there are books I have. I was showing you. I've got the whole, you know, eclipse and apocalypse coming in from like 12,000 years ago. They gave me, like, they laughed. They said,
yeah. So the essence of, I think, what you're talking about is what we've been saying about it's all frequency based, right? Everything is a frequency. So the food, the water, the air, all of the different things that are frequencies in and of themselves. Right. We are inhabiting with our own frequency set, right? And that frequency set is going to be affected by how well you pay attention to it. Where is the attention of your intention?
Yeah.
You know, Tom and I talked about this, about changing the frequency of the language of the word and the importance of making sure that the words that you're using, the and the intent behind those words, with the definition of those words.
Yeah.
Dom, you know, he was going on about how I love the statement he made about, you know, his people and his tribes, saying that, you know, the world is perfect. It's just there's a bunch of people having a very bad conversation.
Say the least. But...
yeah, and that conversation has been manipulated and mangled, and I call it the carefully crafted, curated narrative that is designed to change the frequencies within the mind, which is not the brain. The brain, and the consciousness and the mind are the expression of the individual frequency stamps that we are from the infinite field, the frequency of energy, of consciousness. And that's just my view of it. But when I got to that point, it simplified everything, because I went through the theological side of it. I had a Christian ministry back in the early 80s in a Pentecostal church, and I'm one of those people that when I get into something, I don't do dive head first or feet first. I do a jackknife. And I went straight into that, and we did the speaking in tongues, laying on hands on the sick, casting out devils, doing all this stuff. And what I saw was an expression of intent that was focused on the frequencies through the words that were being used to affect an outcome. And I saw some fascinating stuff that I'd never seen before. Frequency manipulation. And I went, wow, what's going on here? And the more I looked into it, I had more questions. The more questions I asked, the fewer answers I got, to finally a common answer of, well, you just have to have faith. You just have to believe. And I said, you know, I appreciate that, but I'm, and I didn't know the word at the time, but I, yeah, it was polluting everything that I was experiencing and the path that I was on, because I was told that this is the way it was and you don't have to understand it, you just have to accept it. So the more questions I asked, the less answers I got, the more common of it's got to be faith. And I said, you know, there's this thing about knowing. And when I later found the word gnosis in the Greek for knowledge, and what it really means is not just knowing something, it's feeling it in your bones. You feel the frequency of that knowledge, of that knowing. And that's a whole different level of understanding and awareness for me.
One of the things that I think, you know, you brought in is again, back to the whole linguistics. And this is what I've taught for a long time. And it's something like, you know, I used to get called up to go help the tribes. Okay, so it's not like, and I'm not, like I said, I'm not Native and I'm certainly not Aboriginal. I'm off my own tribes. I don't need to be adopted in or get new names and go through ceremonies that are not necessarily ours or for the most part have been corrupted. You know, you see these things with these alliances of indigenous nations, right, that aren't, that they just call women clan mothers and they just call themselves chiefs and they should be able to be charged with fraud and mischief. And you've got stolen valor for the military. We should have some version of it too. But, you know, when people are using these words like God, those are not original words. Mm-hmm. Those actually are very Illuminati draconian. We would say you speak with forked tongue because we know it. It doesn't, a mother and a father create a child. They don't God a child. You can even hear it in the thing. You create, you procreate, and you co-create. It's got a soft flow to it. It's truth. And even in those original languages, you know, in there. So there's something called tribal laws, Mr. Meredith Quinn. And there's a set of books actually that I'll just bring in here quickly. That he did, and Timothy Phillips does one. I do some occasionally with Lisa Wolf at and Tim Phillips and some other people that are hereditaries. And these are some of the white tribes. Like, people don't realize the white tribes, we have all our own clan mothers. We have our sacred kin domains. We have our treaties, whether it's Noah's Ark or all the Kamatic to Cleopatra. We've had them for thousands of years. You know, we have tartans, just like we've got totem poles. We have stuff that goes back, and we don't have to do it. But these are some of the books here, you know, that go back. And this is one translation I have, which is a lot. But the Dakota, the Eagle Clan, we were just talking about, you know, things like that. But the time, the pole shift, gifting, equations, math, quantum math, everything's in here. To me, this is the missing books of the Bible, right? And I don't want to get into the bibliotheque of that because, like you, I did like a theology background for years. I was fascinated, right? And then I realized the people I was hanging out were being trained in the craft, Masonic crafts, right? Which is the priest craft, the lawyer craft, the doctor crafting, the nurse crafting. They all have this craft thing, and they've been twisted. And when you look at a lot of the original books that were actually from the North American continent, that were hidden in the bowels of the Vatican. And I know people that have been down there and read some of the books. I said, I need to talk about the Book of the Word of the Lords. It talks all about clan mothers, which we were called the angels or the angles, but the angels of pure light, the virgin women, the queens of the heaven, the celestial women, right? And again, they appointed all the men. You can see that in the Last Supper. If anyone looked beyond here and went up top, there was the Bear Clan up there. Or you'll see what was with Queen Elizabeth. You'll see the tribe of Judea with the lion. And opposing it was the Arcturian clan mother. So I've got stuff that goes back there. I have case law from the States with Judge Urban, Warren Keith Urban, back in there, right back to Wounded Knee, back to consolidated stuff, to up here. Judge Curran in the 1800s said very clearly the white clan mothers and the indigenous clan mothers have title over a loyal title, entitled, like Jupiter ascending, have title to over the States and Canada. And those are some of the things that people need to learn. And when you come away from, what the thoughts are, what is your law? If they think that the Old Testament and the New Testament and an eye for an eye is their law, and the limited spectrum of what was in there, then they're missing things. Or if you get into the New Testament, or you look at everything, the pseudepigraphica, I've read the apothecary, I've read the Gospel of this, the Book of this, the Book of the Dead, the Book of whatever, Santos Bonacci. I spent 15 years ago, him and I did shows together. He was going to get me my own show. I was going to be a female counterpart to him. Like, you'd imagine him, Jordan Maxwell, Michael Cesare,
Oh,
me, Santa, right?
that would have been just
David
a
Icke, right? Like, I was like, oh, yeah, I think I could, but that life has a way of changing things. And it was just because of what happened with my children and the legal stuff and my ex being a lawyer. I mean,
Well,
that's how I learned all about children and molestation and adrenochrome and trafficking. And I've been at trying to stop this since 1997. It's my
and
been my fight of evil.
this is a whole nother rabbit hole, which is separate from the topic of what we're trying to focus on. But it's extremely important because I know,
I'm going to tie it in a minute.
when I discovered Michael Sarian and when Ben Stewart did the Esoteric Agenda and Chimatica,
Yeah, I
started
love those.
talking about helping to have an understanding of the delineation of how some of these laws and some of these different things have come into play and the impact that they have had on the way that we view the societal fabric that we inhabit, because we're, first of all, individual sovereign frequency stamps, because we come from the consciousness and the energy fields created us. We came out of that. So we are sovereign in the sense of self. In that origin of our frequencies that make us, that animate us and make us who we are and represent here. But this is the Alex Jones model, a prison planet in a lot of ways, because the folks that are running the prison, the guards and the administrators and all of that, have purposely created this chaos of confusion to get into the consciousness, cause a bunch of chaos in the mind, in the consciousness, which then spills out as language that's polluted and diluted, and then causes a really bad conversation, as Tom says. So we're going to have to do another show on that, and I'm really looking forward to diving deep there. But once people start realizing that the reality that we inhabit has been purposely mangled and manipulated to create the environment we're in, that shedding of that bullshit and getting to the self-examination, going back to what you said earlier, if you don't love yourself, and love starts with knowing who you are, if you don't do that introspection, that self-examination, self-reflection, and you're constantly checking, why do I think this way? Why do I feel this way? why has my life path been as it has been? And you go through that examination and you get honest with yourself. Going again back to what Tom was talking about, having that pure, honest conversation with yourself through authenticity, through integrity. What is it about me that makes me? And what has all of this stuff that I inhabit, the lineage and the environment and all those things, how have they contributed to how I think and how I act and what I do and how I use myself, this biological meat suit, to navigate the reality that I'm inhabiting? The frequency sets, to me, is what it all goes back to. I harp on about this, and interestingly enough, I haven't been called out for it with all the shows that I've done on it. I keep getting encouraged to talk about it. So I'm either confusing them or I'm resonating with them, or maybe a little bit of both. But to me, it's the simplicity of the frequencies, the simplicity of understanding reality from the energetic frequency sets that make up our unique expression, and the fact that we are just another part of this infinite field of frequencies, which takes me to the next part of what I'd like to talk to you about today. Modern modalities.
Okay.
Modalities.
Yeah.
We've talked about, and you've gone on very eloquently about all of these other elements of the lineage and the histories and the genetics and how all of those things have resulted in who and where and what we are today.
Right.
It seems to me, and in particular, you and I have talked about this in the many hours that we've gone on talking about all these different things, that there is another common element to the healing and the health and the wellness that has come from the ancient traditions and is now, oddly enough, and I are a geezer geek, and so I have a certain affinity and dive that I do regularly into the technology space.
I love that part.
And in technology, there are some fascinating, wonderful things that are not only here now, but they are going to be extremely influential and important and profound as we get around the dumpster fire that we're all kind of dancing around right now and trying not to get either tossed in or get, you know, burned up by shrapnel, right? But one of the things that you have brought to my knowledge and experience that I think is extremely fascinating that I'd like to talk about is the frequency healing, the Genius app that that you have been working with. Let's talk about what is that and the frequencies that are used within that app that make such a profound difference.
I think it's amazing. Like, you know, in all my career for healing, it all comes down to, and we do, we create, we talk with people. If we're not telepathic, but our voice comes out, and it can either be the sweetest thing to tell someone you love them, and just the tonation of it, you could tell someone, I love you, or love you. That tone, and that's the most thing, you know, physical beating or emotional ritual abuse, sexual abuse, whatever, nothing hurts worse than the tongue. I think we can all go back to a time when we remember where we were loved and cherished and warm. If I said, I want you just to close your eyes and think of something peaceful, something will come to you. If you think of something when someone scolded you or, you know, put something into your mind, your frequency. And again, you don't even have to sometimes say anything. It's just the way people look at you. It's what they emanate off the auric field. And so way back in early 2005, 2006, and of course, by that point, I was like into Reiki and everything else and learning all this stuff and, you know, that, well, this tribal treaty law beats everything, karma, everything, hanging out with Winston Schaut, doesn't matter who it is, right? You know, I got it. But they kept saying and kept encouraging me that say, no, you got to do something different. And so I was at a trade show, health show at one point, and these people had this incredible, like, $30,000 tech machine. I'm like, holy jeez. And I could interface, and it does, whether people like it works with what they call machine learning, ML. Okay, some people call it AI. I like to think of it as genetics, and there are certain things that can be actually very helpful with genetics interfacing. If I have a piece of copper, or I have an organite piece here. These are all natural metals and crystals and herbs and everything and elements from the earth. That's all we're doing. We're just recreating it into a computer, or we're recreating it into an iPad or something. And they do. There is a whole non-terrarian component to it. But there are things, if you know about the secret space program, you also learn about how many different things, Octarian different ships, they cannot fly unless the DNA or the frequency is there. You just have to put your hand in and do the mind meld thing. Okay? And that's similar how we actually operate when you come and, you know, with some meet with someone else, whether it's here or I meet with someone within my proximity, your energy and aura field changes. Everything changes. And so that's one of the things is, you know, a lot of people talk about, you know, wanting to be enlightened and everything else. And I'm going, you know, it gets back to, and I'll swing back to this in just a sec, but I think this is an important component, is how you love yourself again. For example, I'm not for chattel or hire, right? I don't have a license. I don't need permits to run on my vehicles. You know, the idea of taxation is abhorrent to me. That's usury, right? I haven't done any of that for a long time. I have a seal on here, you know. They don't bother me. They haven't, because they know the law. They're getting to know it bigger and bigger. The problem being is, a long time ago, it was just me standing in the courtroom getting my arm broken by a sheriff. Now, again, it's the frequency, and now they learn to understand. And when I don't have that kind of stuff, it will come to me. So when I went to these health shows trying to learn more stuff, I was shown some of this technology back like 25 years ago. It wasn't new. We all knew about Halda Clark. I got Halda Clark stuff and had a Kruger stuff here and all sorts of stuff. I was playing with the Tesla things and all sorts of stuff here, plates and water and crystals and whatever. And sound, I have plates that plug into the sound speakers and stuff too, but they attach to the genius. And way back then, I saw all this and I started reading these machines better than the people trying to sell them to me or do readings. And I was like, I did. I knew it. I don't know how to explain it, but I knew it. And I could look at something. I could see whether someone was in congestive heart failure or was going to have a cerebral vascular incident, right? And they weren't navigating it the way I guess I would or should or did. And way back then, there was myself, another wonderful instructor and teacher. I think she's amazing, is Dr. Deborah Stewart. Dr. Debbie Drake out of Toronto. And she has something called healthcounts.ca. She's one of the few people like myself that zinc has a certain hertz or frequency, has a certain color on the spectrum. So everything has a biophotonic and that biochromatic. And so when you learn this, we could start giving medicine without a license, but more importantly, we could do it naturally. But that's what they're doing in the direct energy weapons things. And you'll hear people talk about all the stick or the venomization that's happening, because some of it's semi-synthetic and some of it, they're beaming it to you. In these books, 5,000-6,000 years ago, they talk about the frequency that they're using, St. John the Divine, but how the Catholic Church and the reptilian are using mind control weaponry and frequencies to dumb you down. And we know this because I just got off a thing too. I was talking with the what's called V2K, voice to skull. So they can also send you messages and give you thoughts and imprint thoughts. They're not yours. So we have to decide, is this mine or is it coming from outside of me? And that's where you need to be very stable. So I'm very much about one, getting the alkalinity and the pH, which we'll talk about. Because in order for our technology to work better or water to be absorbed, you need to be alkaline. And so I'm very big on teaching that. And I'll show you how that ties in with the frequency here in a minute. But the frequency, or what's called litmus paper, is this. It's a simple strip. And that's like, which chakra do you want to live in? 3D, 4D, 5D, or get all the way up to 8D. And that's really what you do. You measure your first morning urine. And we have all sorts of things that we're using, because everything has a hertz. So if I make a yoni pearl like this, a vaginal pearl, most women don't know where they are, quite frankly. They don't know their own systems. They have become bodies, discombobulated too.
Yeah, they don't know how to feel. Manipulated in some very nefarious and very just nasty ways. That's one of my little rants is, when I see what's going on in the estrogen-based carbon units
Yep.
around the world, the manipulation of the mind, which is then translated into the body, and the way that it's been just severely mangled. We now have, in fact, I saw this term the other day, and I thought it was clever, and it was called the awfuls, the AWFL, and it's angry white female liberals. And I thought to myself, when I stay out of, the political thing and try to stay out of the ideologies, but you can't avoid it. You have to be obvious. You have to be observational with it, and you have to look and see what's going on. And I got to tell you, the majority of people that I see that have gone into those kinds of ideologies, they don't look well. They're not healthy. They look pale. They look angry. They look aged. And you can see, and essentially what I'm getting to is that the language has become a mental parasite, which is clearly affecting the biological system that they inhabit. And I think that, again, it's all frequency based, but in the approach to the Genius app and what you're doing, and from what I've seen, it's really interesting to me that there is a blend of the ancient knowledge frequencies, like you're talking about in the book. Everything they knew what the frequencies were, right? And they specifically focused on those frequencies and using them for health and wellness, for a balanced feng shui within your biological system, right? And I think that that is something that is going to be extremely important, and people are going to start, they can use a tool like this and the knowledge to find out who the hell they are, why they are, and what they need to do to optimize themselves, how to get an optimal flow of frequencies within your biological system so that you can navigate a more productive and positive path within the reality that we inhabit. If I hope that made some sense. I just you triggered that in me, and so it's your fault.
I'm glad I triggered things in you. You should hear conversations when we're not on air. Anyway, one of the things too, and I just want to bring it, I'll go into that, and maybe this is a great time to whip over to my Facebook, if you could kindly go into
Okay,
those albums and stuff.
absolutely.
So these are technologies that have been put onto phones, iPads, and whatever, and carrying clunky equipment like in the hospital is kind of out of date. And part of the thing too, that's why I talk about things when people are getting into tapping, EFT, neuro-linguistic programming, using words like God instead of creator. Everything you say has got a vibration and a frequency. And I learned this very early when I was recovering people and helping them through residential schools being scooped up, and the trauma, post-traumatic stress, sexual abuse and stuff, is that the language is so important, because they were actually, you go in your original mother's tongue actually. So there is a couple of different things. I'm bringing you guys to Facebook just to look at this for a reason, because that's actually where I store a lot of stuff over the years. You'll see some very, I think, things that would blow most people's minds. I just did a show actually going the great alignment. It's mind blowing, Carol, there at on that on Rumble. Okay, so if we go into one in here, you'll see, and I'm just going to go through here for just a sec just to orientate you. There is one hopefully up there that will get up, which will be healing modalities, what we're doing. One of the things I did is I talked about live microscopy, because how it ties into 5-6G right now, and using things other than drugs as alternative. Because when you tie into a drug, what's going to happen is that you're going to be tying in and co-creating with that individual, and that's usually not where I want to go. So there's a whole bunch of stuff you'll see. Dr. Robert Young, there's always controversy about a lot of us, and he is bona fide, got a very strong acrylic impact today, more than most people I've ever seen. But I want you just to go back in through there, and we'll just quickly rip through. So if you just go right down to the bottom, I've been doing a lot of shows. This one was developed from when I did it, Quantum Chit Chat on BitChute and on Telegram. We talk about spirochetes. We talk about what's in there, the nanotechnology, how people are actually becoming alive. There's Lorraine and myself at True Health Canada in there. And as we scoot down just to the bottom, you're going to see a bunch of pictures. So I want you to see what I did. I brought actually the first vials in front of a judge, a tribal judge, actually, and I was also a Juris Doctorate in Washington. But myself, Lorraine Andres, and Dr. Ross Anderson brought them in there. So this is why I'm really quick about you guys just going in, and you could just whip through these really quick if you want. So again, we took the vials. I took the sound there, and that was with the Genius biofeedback. So we wanted to see what I could use with the biofeedback and using the sound, because people were infected through everything, water, food, including most people don't realize it, the nasal and the oral swabs were actually an implantation, no different than taking an injection. And this has been the biggest thing. Most people are absolutely horrified, and they don't realize that we classify you as vaxxed or a homo hyborg genesis mutation now. So these were the biggest causes, more so. We tested, friends of mine tested basically all the different forms of ivermectin. We found that they were all glowing. They all had biochips, just like being tracked. So they can see you glowing from your butt to the space station, unfortunately. So this is one of the ones I started testing. You'll see what I started doing there. There's my little Hopi tobacco plant I was trying to save with the electrical culture. It didn't work too well, but that's okay. I tried. But I want you to see what's on that plate. That's like a Tesla Genus plate there. And that was actually the tobacco, if you go back one. That was actually the tobacco I was trying. So there is actually tobacco nicotine infused liquids, okay, or in homeopathics and stuff. And so what we were doing is we were testing them, and we could like muscle test them to the client and see if you needed them or not, which eliminates all your allergy testing, right? But more importantly is we could give them frequency, and we could give them the pure essence of the creator's tones. Because anytime you bastardize or mutate it, it's like when you've slept with someone, you're no longer a virgin. And this is what's happening with the genetics and the allopathics that they're using out there. So these are really supposed to be only used for pure things. But yeah, we'll just whip through there. So that's actually a little bit of what I do. So this is the background to the Genus biofeedback. You can see that we can actually do these on oscilloscopes. And this is the brilliant stuff that Ryan Williams does. So he's developed probably 30 some technologies over the years, the life, the infinity, the wave machine, and then the Genius, another form of Rive, and then something called the Odyssey, which of course they made a lot of knockoffs lately. So this is something from one of my talks. You know, how do you like that for the first live blood cell machine when you're starting to get into Tesla and Royal Rife and radionics? So I was
Nice.
testing some of that. So this is the kind of technology that we're bringing in there, right? And so now what we can do is you can go to YouTube. It's called Shattering Cancer with Frequencies. It's by Dr. Anthony Holland. And I love it. I used to call it the Kaboom 20 years ago. So when they would have me come to Vancouver or wherever I was teaching or Saskatoon on the road, we had this picture and we showed you that the cancer cell, the pancreatic thing, the leukemia, the whatever disease you had, diabetes, depression, whatever, we could run a sound wave and match it and shatter that, even the thought form, like a, you know, think of it like a virus or an opera singer when she shattered that glass. And you can shatter people's paradigms, right? So these negative depression, bipolar, you know, post-traumatic stress, we could do this by sound. It wasn't just music and uplifting. Wow, we could start going in. And so you could give the frequency of a raindrop massage. So I actually have that built into my Genius, by the way. So I took all my essential oils and I plated them on so I could give you basically an energetic, spiritual, quantum raindrop massage.
So
Right.
let me get some clarification on that.
Okay,
What
you
it
do.
what you're doing, and I love this image, by the way. I mean, this is awesome, but what you're doing is you're of the healing essence that you're talking about. When you put them on the plate, you're actually getting the frequency of that essence
That's correct.
and finding whatever hertz and frequency range it functions within. And then you're translating that into the app so that that frequency is now a known frequency set that can be used to find harmonize with the frequencies that are that need it or out of balance with it, so that you can essentially transfer the frequency without actually having the substance.
Correct. So we can also then not only do it to you, there's myself with Pascal Najati, who's quite famous for what he's been doing and cutting the head of the snake off in Geneva and going after Pfizer. But you see, one of my esteemed colleagues, and I'm now one of his alkaline life coaches, he calls me. Anyway, it's Dr. Robert O. Young. Anyway, and I loved him. It's like Dr. Gary Young in hand. We could also take the water here, okay? And let's say most people and most springs or stuff like that are very acidic. So if I tested it, you don't look too hot. Like, say, that's the 3D water. That's like old stuff. However, if we start putting things like baking soda into it or into you, what I did is I actually played it because I live at probably one of the most beautiful glacial waters and lakes ever up here in the mountains. And we can actually put in things, whether you put in baking soda or other things, it holds the memory from the beginning of the planet if you're in the right place at the right time. And then you can see what I just did by adding just a few drops to it. Okay, that's where you want to be vibrating. So what I can do is also when people are ill, it's not just teaching them how to go back into 3D and do the substances. You become what you are. So I could actually take this and imprint anything I want almost in the planet. So that's called a database. So the difference with the genius is Ryan basically made us the genius biofeedback program here. And what we did is that we all co-create with him. So I'm not being run by a corporation and things like that. So we'll just go through these really quickly here. But this is actually the rife. This is one of the ones he did. These are very reasonable. Like I'm talking that these are like $20,000, $30,000 less than what's out on the market or going into rooms with people running it. You can run this off your phone, a lot of these for under a couple hundred dollars. And so we don't need to be professionals or doctors or all this kind of crap. So I actually want that into there. And so those bunch of like credentials, by the way, if you just back up, just so you know, I'm from the old school in there. That is the universities of integrative quantum medicine. So I'm technically a quantum biofeedback technician. I'm also a specialist. I'm also a peristeem therapist. I'm a colon hydrotherapist, all sorts of things. I have about 30 different little certificates behind here, all of which none of them are going to be paid for or belong to any associations, including the registered nurses, right? So they can't stop me. But these are the kind of things that you need to know. This is how real nurses were doing things. So we can either hook up clients, which I don't do too much anymore because it's pretty dangerous, especially if you know you got to ask the background. You can't use do these on people that are with pacemakers injected lately with that or the PCR. Menstruating, breastfeeding, all sorts of things. Again, these are common things you should ask because they're better times to do it, or you do them in what we call subspace or what you call remote healing, distance healing, or telemedicine. So we can do it a different way, or I'm going to put it, if someone was PCR'd or vaxxed, I'd put it into the water and make them a remedy. I'm not going to hook them up with, you know, basically like electrodes that can change them. So this is an example of hooking yourself up. I mean, it doesn't get any much simpler than that, does it? So you actually put your voice into it. So it's voice activated. This is very much what they did at, it's called Fast Fournier. But your voice has a frequency. And what it does is when you put it on, Ryan developed some of the algorithms and he converted all those $30,000 heavy duty scale, indigo, whatever machines, Quest machines, into one of the first portable ones. And so he really is the pioneer of all this. And I love him because he's got the greatest ethics and the Insight Health is all basically, you know, all run by, you know, him and his relatives. Again, it's so important. That was me with Dr. Ross Anderson a couple years ago. And again, we were helping people, again, that were injected. He himself touched someone that was vaccinated and was paralyzed in his bed and dying for about 3 weeks before I got to him. So this is me looking at the recovery phase and making sure what's going on because we're close in proximity to Lytton Hope, which was like what happened at Maui. So again, you've got to see what's going on. So yeah, you can just whip through these. We'll go through them really quick here. See if there's anything that exciting in here. And again, Lorraine and I did a lot of testing. You know, you've got to be able to back it up. And that's that, you know, what does the sound do? And we could see it. This is how I got Lorraine, and she was doing live blood cell. And when she saw what I was doing at the biofeedback, she said, "You can do more in half an hour, Karen, than I would have been able to get getting them to switch their intake and their diet in 6 months." So Lorraine and I, she's one of my top therapists. This is me in Calgary playing with dental surgeons, a biological dentist. We were putting the blood on and doing what's called PFR. So I took my blood out, similar to stem cells, and put him on. I was the first one to get bloody and doing stuff like this, but with a purpose, putting it back. We now have had a couple of people doing EBU, which is taking out the blood, like hemodialysis, running it through an ozone generator, extracorporeal ozone, and then they feed it back to the system. And there are now a couple of people that are using similar things to the genius. We're running it through a genius plate and creating a different electrical magnetic plate. Also, like Tony Pantelresco's, they're creating it's called a triangle or a bucket where you're changing and you actually can change the whole electrical magnetic grid in there. You could put like a penny in and it will float within the space. So that's very much like what David Sarita was doing, right, with the levitational stuff. So this is the kind of stuff I play with in the background. So the holographic blood to me is doing that. And again, this is me talking about reversing engineering, using the biofeedback. And of course, at that time, doing it in front, I wanted a bona fide judge, lawyer, tribal, whatever at that point. So anyway, that stuff I did years ago. So we've had a little bit of play. So anyway,
Yeah.
yeah, just wanted you to be aware of that and what's available. So we'll just go back to this.
We'll put those links in the description so that people can go and look at them in detail, because I was scrolling through earlier and I looked through and I went, oh my God, there's like 10 hours of stuff that can be gone through here. That If you the thing is that you have to get to a point, and this has been a common thread throughout our conversation here, where you have to stop and you have to have a rethink. You have to stop and go, no, wait a minute. What I have been told, taught, shown, given, adopted, created on my own, of my own foolish and nefarious fooling around and trying to figure out what it is that makes me tick. Why do I see all of this illness and these people, like Tom says, having a bad conversation? They're having not only a bad conversation externally, but they're having a bad in conversation internally. And that is something that has to change. That's one of my purposes of having these conversations on the Nexus. The nexus being where everything connects, because there is a connection. There is an innate, fundamental characteristic of connection that's based on frequencies and vibration. And that frequency and that vibration is going to be extremely, it's either going to be really powerful on the positive side, or it's going to be really powerful on the negative side. And understanding the fundamentals of frequencies and how the ancients knew it. And we now are coming to a great reveal of that ancient knowledge, which is why your story and what you bring to the conversation is just unbelievably fascinating. And most importantly, it's important and it's profound for the future. You are a part of this transformative disruption that I think we're going through. And we've only begun to have this conversation. We scratched the surface on it today. And
Do we have a
I'm
few
go ahead.
minutes to look at that other Facebook one where it
Oh,
says
yeah,
now?
absolutely.
What I'd like to do is just, if we have a few minutes, I just want to take that and then afterwards I'll show you how simple it is to use the technology because I don't want people thinking you have to like have these kind of credentials because you don't. Most of my the people that are in there that I've done thousands and thousands and thousands over the years. Is that basically it's in usually grandparents' hands, quite frankly, because they want to protect their grandchildren now. So it's not something that we need to be techie on there. But if we go back to, we'll just get out of that and go to my straight up to the albums again.
Okay.
And we'll just scroll
Look
all
at
the way
all
up.
this information, people. I mean, come on. This is a place where you can spend days getting absorbed into amazing stuff.
So if we, yeah, go back straight to the albums, to the photos.
Photos.
Yeah, and then now what
albums.
we're gonna, yeah, go back into albums. Okay, so we're gonna scroll down there. It will say heal everything. Now, oh, wait, it's got 66 items. That's the one I want. Just before we go in there, can you guys see at the bottom here? Those are things that I want you to take a look at. When I talked about genetics and mitochondrial, you'll see what I'm talking about. Those are my coat of arms. Those are my DNAs. Those are my heralds. Those are my crests that the military works. Those are actually some of the copies of some of the stuff I went to go arrest the Queen with, Queen Elizabeth, when I put in for international warrants. Synchrotrons, everything that you're dealing with now with the ellipse, eclipse, that sort of thing, the kachinas, the prophecies, everything's in there. So that's the background to that. So if you look at that heal everything now, we'll just make it real quick. And then next to that will be the genius. But I want you to take a look, and we're just going to whip through these like every 5 seconds. I can speak quick. In here, this is what's called a sitz bath. Okay, so we upgrade that. Anyone can do that. Herbs, oils can be done. And what do I do with that water? I put them on my genius frequency bio plate. So the water has been frequency implanted before it gets up to you. So we have different ways to get things in. This will be the steam version. So this is a safer version, by the way, instead of going into sweat lodges and getting everyone's negative energy dumped on you. So yeah, we'll just go hit the sidebar. Yeah, I want you to see how deep this stuff is penetrating, guys. This is not just going into someone's vagina or prostate, okay? We do animals, children, pediatrics. I've done cats, dogs, all sorts of variations of it. So this is called a steam, and it's an individual, basically, sweat lodge. So we'll just keep going. These are chairs, and we'll just keep going through all of these. These are called, again, I'll go to the end saying like vagina in 20 different languages. I want you to stop here for a sec because this is hilarious. This is my favorite thing. This is in Georgia. It's called the sweet spot. Okay, it's like the honeypot thing. It's like, the creme de la creme. I want you to see that there are women and clinics doing this all over. This is Atlanta, Georgia, by the way. We have got thousands and thousands. I've trained with Kelly Garza at something called the Steamy Chick. So I'm a steamy chick. Didn't know that, did you? So I don't tell you everything at first. Then I'm also part of a lot of things I haven't told you yet. Anyway, but what happens is that this is also called the Red Tent Wellness. And I've trained with also Lisa Kelly. So I want you to see, because most people don't know, and the top elite clinics all around the world have this for men and women. And I'm going to show you one here where one of the famous doctors is. So again, crockpots. Again, this is who Dr. Terry DeBrow is. If you don't know who he is, he's a famous plastic surgeon, Hollywood, and with botched. These are clinics run by doctors for doctors and other people. So this is also the Hollywood Housewives. There's Heather. Okay. So this has been on the doctors. Terry was bright enough to actually decide to go take swabs before and after. And they showed that everything, all the parasites, frequencies, candida, yeast, all of them, this was the most effective way of dealing with it. So why go to a doctor? So like we did the old facial steams, this again goes through the root chakra, but into the blood system. And you can do full body, whatever you want in here. But again, we can use crystals. That's a $3,000 chair I tried to get up here. But I have found since then, I still think going to basics is better. Cedarwood, natural elements, right? So we'll just whip through this as quick as you can, Robert. Again, there are benefits to this, and it talks about cancer. This is my number one thing for depression, cancer, post-traumatic stress. It burns out the sensors of fungus, bacteria, viruses, and parasites. Okay, it aligns the chakras. It's great for pain, it's great for libido. These are done scripturally, if anyone actually ever read the scriptures. I read way too many times, right? This is what they were talking about, right? This is how they actually cleansed and purified before they actually married. And this is where the beginning rituals were to having a bachelor party and a bridal shower. They did these steamings. You can see them on gold and silver things in the pyramids and in the Chinese dynasties. And of course, Russian, we had our own, Bannock things. Again, you can buy one of these, like, $150 on things or do a hot plate. This is what I wanted to get across. This is what women don't know. These are called sacred womb, or basically yoni pearls, or vaginal womb detox. And what comes out of people and women, this is how they did parasite cleansing. Just like you put a nicotine patch on, or I use also dental, like cigarette, like almost a, when people do like a joint, you can actually use herbal, like a cigarette, and put it into here too. Same idea. Takes about 2, 3 days to absorb that. And this is what they did for 3 months. Again, they go into the root chakra. Everyone is missing how to do it. So yeah. Right? And again, this is the kind of stuff that comes out of women. And this is the conversation we need to have. because this is also what transfers from men and can be stored in you, dormant, or your whole life, and then passed down onto the next generation. And if we don't start cleaning it now, once you start cleaning yourselves, especially with biofeedback, it makes a huge difference. So I wanted to bring your attention. Again, go look it up. As you can see, go to Google, put vaginal pearls, yoni pearls, put whatever you want. Buy them or make them. I usually make my own because it's not rocket science to get a 2x2 gauze, natural fabric, put in a tea bag in, half a tea bag, and put some string on and greased up. Don't call me because you can look up these words called yoni steam herbs. That's why I made these libraries for you guys. Mugwort, motherwort, and again, what's the number one thing they talked about in Revelations? At the end days, they would be the blood in the streets would be there, and they would perish because of Chernobyl and Wormwood. There's your thing. So just like HDQ that Trump talked about, come on, people, go look it up. Quinine is called shikona bark. It's also called Jesuit's bark for a reason, and China bark, and that's not from the CCP. So these are simple things. I'm a colon hydrotherapist because again, you get diverticula, you get things getting stuck in there, and that's why I use the biofeedback. Because then I use it in the enema water and look at the kind of stuff I can start pulling out. And I just want you to think of it. That's not poop. That's biofilm. That's negative energy. That is emotional negative energy, ancestrally stored. So it's very amazing. I used to have dark brown eyes when I started nursing. You should see my nursing photos from the 80s, with the cute little white hat and all that and sort of thing. And my eyes are actually blue now. That's just from cleansing. They're blue and gray now, right? Okay, so we'll just skip through that. So that again is again learning. There are books on this, there are schools on this, and too bad most people, this was the thing that the clan or the wisdom tribes. When we do iridology, it all ties into the colon, and the colon is called the neural arc reflex, and that was when you're in the womb, you're gestating, you are one big colon from your mouth down to the butt. And that's all you do is you're juicing in salt water, so water and electrolytes and urine, which is the way that why we're going to heal it again.
One big colon applies to a whole bunch of other things that I'll save for later, but I mean
I do.
we're seeing a whole bunch of one big colons walking around now.
Yeah, that's where the term is colonized, by the way. I have a whole thing that they actually removed that they got back on Rumble from Project Ascension because I talked about the whole linguistics and the law thing of how do you die in state. Intestinal, okay, all those words are in there. Colonized, colon, everything. This is again, if you don't know herbs, sexual abuse, ritual abuse. You might think it's a nice thing, but we're using those herbs. These is combined at 102 hertz frequency to get into where women and boys are traumatized or sodomized when they're young. So this goes into the actual acupuncture point, so that's where it's designed to go. So you could rub it on the, lower abdomen, perineum. This is one that I use with everyone. And it's called Peace and Calming. Don't buy all the stuff. Just go get your own. I have like three, four suppliers from Nevesson's up here to Eden's Gardens to Essential Aura to Key Aroma. Again, you can get a lot of these oils for like next to nothing, just a few dollars compared to paying $30 for someone's brand name. But these are the things that actually change the brainwave. They're all frequency done. And all these things, Robert, I'm showing you, these are imprinted. All of these substances are imprinted directly into my genus biofeedback. So not only can I test it for you, I could give you a whole aromatherapy session. I could give you a flower essence thing. In the old days, I used to do stuff, and it's still one project Ascension with the old skill, but I did a therapy with someone for 3 hours, and by the time I gave him copper for 3 minutes, he could taste like a copper plate, like a penny in his mouth. And then I actually did some oils and they could start smelling it in the room. We used to do that for fun. Okay. So it's not magic, it's quantum medicine and physics and runs through here. So again, very simple things. So we'll just, again, frequency stuff. If you're not used to it, one drop of peppermint is like you taking 26 cups of peppermint tea. Cheap ways to put different Celtic salts in. This gives you all 97 minerals. Why are we going out and buying these like expensive things? Isolate. I need this for glutathione. I need this for NAC. I need whatever. This is the substance. It is like not even pennies. I could go out to my lake and actually get all the salts off of it for free.
And then this
That was
just goes
called
back
away.
to the whole concept of homeopathy and
Exactly.
tinctures, right? Which
Right there.
isn't necessarily ancient, although it is kind of ancient, but when it started to become more widely used, and people were focusing on being able to do it. It's 150, 200 years ago that it became popular once again, until the folks that were, running the systems and lording over the certification and accreditation and all that said, nah, no,
No,
that
dude.
doesn't work. Yeah, okay.
Again, I don't care what salt. And they always go, well, which salt do you get? I said, guess what? I blend all of them. I have Bali, I have Manitou, I have the Dead Sea, I have black salts, I have everything in there. That's how I make my salt sole, by the way. And again, that's what you're doing. Again, in the colon, we've got things like OxyPowder with Dr. Ed Groop's thing and David Wolf. Getting into the small intestine because we're all getting shut down because of the radiation, all getting acidic. Everyone's starting to gain a few more pounds. And this is a great thing for blowing that out. It's amazing. And again, I take oils internally, externally. According to the desk reference you have, I think it was 21 ways to take oils. I made three more. So I invented them. I would know. But again, it's not just massaging. These are done for anxiety, everything else. So all of these blends are put in. We have a whole Young Living section that we've got into there and doTERRA and everyone else is in there. So again, things can go inside and out. So there isn't anything I don't make here. Energy balls, bliss balls, salad dressing will always have, you could have rosemary, oregano in that. So I just wanted to bring it to people's attention because it's so simple, And I just love this. There's nothing like having the essence. And Gary Young was right. He said to me that basically anyone that adulterates this, which is like GMO, right, is like considering a blasphemy against the creator, right? They should all be charged for crimes against humanity, which I intend to do. So
I think that's coming. I'm
it's
right
coming.
behind you on that one.
It is coming. We've got a big international galactic force, a lot of friends around us here. So anyway, I just want you to see this. This is how they were doing this. It's like when you see the truth about cancer, right? It works, guys. We can prove it. I've had thousands of clients do it, and it's not that we're doing it. I do nothing. I know nothing. What it is they're looking at that lifestyle and making those shifts in there, right? Frankett says this is an anti-venom. I always say get, on top of this, get educated. I saw that cover of that book in my head. One time I had a psychic moment with Dr. Gary Young. The minute I got into his field, I had a picture in my head of this whole thing, and he hadn't even told his wife, nor had it been actually put on the market yet. He was still writing it, and yet I saw the cover he had just designed the week before.
Wow.
So, yeah, my one thing for psychic. Well, I had a few more, but anyway, I just wanted to see because people say, "Well, where do you get? Where do you learn?" These are the books I use. I use essential oils in painting. I've trained with Dr. Carolyn Mean. This is the game getting back to the whole linguistics we talked to, right? Because people will say, okay, where are you going to put it? You got anger. It's in my liver. We're going to use purification. It's coded for the liver. We're going to tap. We're going to say this for 21 days. But again, it's in English. So I always suggest if I want it to go back and heal ancestrally, I take that phrase and I put it into Russian Cyrillic, right? Go get a Russian translator. It's not hard. Here's the genius. This is what we're coming to. Again, what you can do is you put this app from Insight Health Apps, or you can get a hold of me, or I'll give Robert some. We're going to give you some links, and that way you can have a free 2 weeks to play with this. And I think it's amazing. It will say I'm trusted because it means you have to trust it yourself because we're not going to make you pay through Apple because you're not. We want to give it out to people for free. So Ryan's done that, so I have a site and Insight Health app will have it that you just go on and just say free download. So you put this on, and basically what you do is you speak into it. And I can do it almost simultaneously. So what happens is that you put your voice into it, and not Robert's voice, my voice. He wants to heal himself, he can do him, or I will do a session for you if you want it. But having said that, this is how simple these things are. So I'm going to go in and just start speaking. I hit a microphone, and can you see how it's starting to pick up my voice? So if I say A-E-I-O-U, it's creating a pattern, an algorithm. A-E-I-O-U, A-E-I-O-U, you. Anyway, what you're going to see is that we are going to create that algorithm. And just like your aura field or the biofield, you're going to see how strong or weak it is. And so we can see what's called psychic attack, entity attachment, Klingons, whatever you want to say. So we can go into things like that. And in here, then we're also going to do a picture. And so what I like to do the picture for, because I can also expand it. So I start looking at things like, iridology, sclerology, the teeth, the acupuncture meridians, where someone, I had a client the other day, she was breaking out, right? And it was actually where it was. Is it in the stomach? Is it in the kidney? Is it in which meridian is it, right? So all those things are part and parcel. So that was that day. I think I have it. Well, can you see how red it was, by the way? I don't know if you can see in that picture.
Oh,
That's
yeah.
actually, I was getting targeted the other day. So I was really having like a heat flush. Okay, so these type of things are, again, things that you can look at and make a difference because I'm healing me. No one else is doing it. And by the way, this goes, I don't do my clients up on the cloud unless I want to screenshot and give them pictures because I don't want people tapping into it because I learned that a long time ago. There are people that can do all sorts of things. So you could take the picture and you could do it of a cat, a dog, or I do the land, or I do the water, or you could do the planet. You could do whatever you want. And then what we're going to start looking is the energetic biofield. Okay, and this is called gas visualization discharge, or actually the human, that's what your immune system is. And so just within seconds, all I have to do is hit one button and I'm going to look at my aura. So I'll see what kind of a field. And if nothing else, you think, what kind of a mood is she in? You really want to know? Yes, I
Yeah.
know.
Sometimes yes, sometimes no.
I don't know if I should show you. But again, all it takes is one or two things to change it. So just because I've been on the computer, I've actually been on computers where they actually hit me. So normally, by the way, I'm usually hitting my cute little glasses and I look very studious like this to protect them. But, on here, like I said, there are all sorts of things. We can be wearing air tamers, copper Q links, all sorts of things. Okay. So in here, I'll just remove me. But you can actually see if I came towards you, that's what I look like. There's a lot of purple, there's a lot of inflammation, and something brown is happening. Okay, so it could be the radiation, it could be the chemtrail and all the rain, or something's off gassing into my field. That's what I want to go in and take a look at. But if you look at my other one, I'm quite angelic, beyond angelic.
Now, this is something that people can, self-diagnosis, like self-medication, is there's just not enough information out there for normies and people who are just starting to explore this whole realm of the biophotonic and bioenergetic aspects of our biology. But this is something that people can actually use for themselves, right?
Right, and this is it, is that I'm not going to a doctor. I don't even have a health card. Okay? I told you I don't have a license. I also don't have any medical cards. I have zero contracts with the government. Okay? Because now in here, so what I'm doing, let's say I don't need to go to Reiki master or whatever. You can align your own as you want to look at chakras. It's got something for everything. So if you're Asian and you want to look at traditional Chinese medicine, we have all the Asian traditional Chinese medicine in there. So you can do your assessments that way. If I wanted to go into looking at, let's say, and I will look at traditional Chinese medicine because it's one of my favorite things. It's actually, as we think Chinese, let's just go back to Tartarian. It was Russian. Russian, Tibetan is, if you look at the words, where it came from. Okay. On here. So I could go in and just within seconds, I've scanned my entire thing head to toe and looked at, went, hey, I need to look at that chakra, or I got a sore arm. So I got frozen shoulder. You would know that one. Okay. And I went like this. And here's a great thing. So what did you experience? What did you notice?
It was amazing. I had we were online. And it was short, like within a day of the injury, and there was all of a sudden I could feel the. It wasn't even a movement; it was like a dissipation. And I said, okay, this is the kind of response and that you would want to get if you had something that was very targeted, very specific to what the out of bound frequency sets of the energy, right? And yeah, it was phenomenal. And then we just listened to it. I listened to it for like 10 minutes, and it was amazing.
Exactly. Now, the fun things in here is we can look at things too. Let's say if, again, a lot of stuff is out of alignment. So, like chakras, you'll see things out of alignment going up and down the spine. Or I can take a look at the spine and just see is it pinched off and there's no flow going through? Or is it in a chronic state of inflammation where it is? So, every, organ is connected here. So, those are the things that we look at. And like I said, it's not a shoulder. I might be looking at something different. So I have a holistic dental program in here. We have a lot of stuff here called oils. So if you like oils, herbs, or what the particular remedy is in here, I made what's called the libraries in here. And I made lots of libraries. And I want to show you why this is different because it's called frequency, shape, and form. And this is where people go and I don't want to touch this. This could be connected to the government and stuff like that. That's why Sabrina Wallace, if you listen to her, I'm probably one of the few people she actually recommends outside of her techie group because of the intense and the cybersecurity that Ryan has put on. This is bar none because he was part of the army. Okay, so we've locked this down that no one gets into it. And on here, I run mine off the grid. So in case, let's say we have a failure, I have a tiny little solar panel that this will run. So I've done this like going camping. So in here, these are the generators that you choose what you want. You can choose the intensity. Okay, you can choose the sound, you can choose piggybacking, you can scan that individual like for Rife and actually run programs just for hormones, just for the depression, just for the immune system or sleeping. But this is the most important thing down here. See where they said all the sine waves? Okay, by the way, sine is a really interesting word, you guys. When they said about, they were sinners in the scripture, they talked about the sine waves. Sine wave is time. I'll be the biggest sinner if I can like arrange that on the planet. Okay, that's how fast you vibrate, right? So a sinner would be way down here, what you call acidic. The sine wave is the purple gamma, like the ultraviolet. That's why we got to be very careful with some of the stuff coming out, like the terahertz and all sorts of things that could disrupt it. They're not for everyone's genetics. So if you were spliced with some genetics compared to our terrarian blood, they might be okay, or they go to chemo and radiation and their hair doesn't fall out, and we do, and we're dying because it's not for everything. And that's why I got into biofeedback, because every one of these things could be actually looked at, including the entire field or the geometry around you. The biogeometry and biosignatures, all those different things. Seeing people learn to gene keys, every modality you can think of. There's things in here we've got with past lives. I've got stuff to do with ETs I made and different what's called alien races. So this is the stuff Ryan made that first page. I made all the rest. These are the ones that I do. So every therapist, you learn to basically co-create with it, and it's tailored to it. So every therapist is different. So how I look and how you and I communicate, we have a open line. So we're basically like, this is my telepathy or psychic, ray to you. Anastasia would call it the divine ray. But again, that's why the intent of the therapist is so important. Okay. That's why I also don't charge my clients. I came out of the money system and don't have banking and stuff a long time ago. Because when you put a charge on it, they don't get the healing. And that's been proven in anything from psychiatry to psychology to whatever, it doesn't matter from Pottinger's cats to all sorts of different things. But when you got into the Kharkov study, it invalidated the whole thing of medicine right there. Because who knows you better than you? You don't know me. I know me. I know what it feels like in here. I know when there's an ache in here. I know something's off. And it's whether this looks at my spidey senses. But just for an example here, where did you ever go to? And this is one of Dr. Debbie Drake's things. She made a train library. We'll just look at the parasites here that she made. Okay. When did you go in and actually scan someone and you looked for all these different parasites here? Okay. Not only did we go in to look at them and identify them, but then we're going to find the right hertz or the frequency for these. Well, this isn't coming as clear as it could be, but these are different things. So is it E. coli? How many worms do you have? And then we're going to take that worm here and then we're going to literally hit the frequency of it. So you could use it like a parasite cleanse. So if I had a tapeworm, it's going to take me 2, 3 weeks to still get rid of that little hookworm or the paintworm or the Mansoni or whatever Americanus or a vampire. There's a vampire Alexis, by the way. There's a vampire thing. Okay. Okay. So where did you go to a doctor and they tested you for this? Where did you get the culture?
Well,
So
the problem is,
exactly.
like we were talking about the allopathic model, they're not even aware of any of this stuff, let alone something that they would consider, doing any kind of diagnosis for or considering in what they're seeing,
I could
looking
take
for it.
anything, MRSA, I could take AIDS, you could take VAIDS, you could take a lot of it. We can't reverse everything. This is a assessment tool. It's one of the things I have, but it's brilliant. And you can combine it with stuff. And like I said, normally what I do is I actually put the water, like I put the sounds into the water, you drink the water. So even better than a homeopathic, it's at the highest vibrational frequency. But again, I want it to be cleaned out. And so one of the things, and I'll just show you some of the stuff that I invented. Because what I did is remember when the venoms all came out? Deb and I knew that there were venoms back in like 2005. It's not new to us. There are thousands and thousands of venoms. So this is the ones I invented. So the red just means that what you need, but look at all the venoms that are out there. Okay? There's a lot more than a crate stain and a couple cobras, right? That may have been rained down or that you picked up or is in your system. I'm not saying it's in the blood or the urine that they can find. It might be sitting in a trace residual of something that you don't know or someone you slept with, by the way. But let me say, for every venom, there's an anti-venom. Okay? And the contact vaccinosis. So tobacco is not something that apparently I need today, but I should look at some turmeric today. And snake root, by the way, is called black cohosh. But again, sexual abuse, ritual abuse, there's so many different things. My lab, I just did some people that think they've been abducted. There isn't anything I'm not prepared to tackle, on here. Right now, I've been doing a lot of stuff to do with, obviously, the sh people think it sheds, but it's being transmitted. It's a transfection. So after hanging out with all my guys, I made live blood cells. So it's kind of like radionically testing your blood so I don't have to draw blood out. And what we did is we found this is probably, Deb and I and Lorraine have found that it's about 98% accurate. So you can't get a better take testing for that. So why would I go take blood out? But I mean, if I want to see some critters, I think it's great. But those are some of the things in here. And I made a lot, let's say, for my children, like also to do with sexual abuse, ritual abuse. It's called post-traumatic stress, things like that, anxiety. I've also got gemstones and crystals. So I've taken a whole bunch of crystals and put them on the plates. And so this is different than someone just thinking and doing, as you think, like Reiki to someone. Because you got the substance, So for example, when I'm looking for something like this, someone's injured, I actually have that vaccine vial. So I can look to see what's in there. And this graphene and the spike stuff. And some of the best things I've found work for some people and don't for other, but this becomes customized, drugless. I've been doing this for 20 some years already. That's why I was teaching. I was one of the first teachers out here in the old days. But now that we have this kind of technology that you can run off of a phone, like, I don't know how we can make it much simpler till we get the right stuff and get the, sort of trinary computers and getting the trivectors and getting like the actual real root gen beds. There's a difference between biophotonic and age regression and longevity beds than what there is for what you're talking about in organ and stem cell regeneration. But they're alone. Like, I mean, you can put one on here and just download this app and scan you and have a nice program while you're sleeping or in the bath or something and have the water pick it up. I put it in for enemas and I've never gotten in like 15 years and doing colon hydrotherapy and enemas and all that and Kalima boards. Is doing the water and then putting that water into the implant and having it sit into the root chakra. It's the fastest thing I've ever seen people pick up. And when you're clean, like in an enema water, and all my guys do this, by the way, if you think this is isolated, people like David Wolf, Gabriel Cousins, Brian Clement, Hippocrates, all the top things, including Marcus Rothkranz. I think Marcus Rothkranz, I give all my clients. One of the things from him, and it's called Heal Yourself 101. So if you don't know about Marcus Rothkranz, you guys should, because he does a whole thing just on enemas. But in here, I can take the frequency of whatever the disease is here. Here's a lexicon. It's simple. You can look at angina, acne, whatever. Pick something, and you just hit play. Does it get much simpler than that? And that's where energetic medicine has come to. So, I mean, I know it sounds strange, but I actually take my yoni pearls and stuff like that, and I put them on with the sound, pick up the frequency, put them in the water, and then put them in the vagina. You know,
So,
you could do the same thing for guys with suppositories.
this is to me genius.
Thank you.
Pun intended.
Thank you.
Intentional pundage otherwise. And this is to me, as I was saying, the direction of technology as it relates to health and wellness going forward. And
Yeah.
oddly enough, it's all based on frequencies. It's a frequency-based reality that we inhabit. And being able to pull all of those different frequencies of the different substances, whether they're used for healing or they're used for identification of some kind of illness or some kind of out of phase frequency with what will be optimal for your biological system to function. It's bridging the gap. It's bringing all of that together. Now, it's going to take a lot of education. It's going to take a lot of people getting around and through their own whatever issues they may have as it relates to both technology and to what do you mean you can put a frequency of frankincense into your phone? Excuse me? I mean, there's going to be a lot of that, but that doesn't mean that it doesn't work or that it's not real. And I think that's one of the things that is extremely important about what you're doing with it, what Ryan's doing with it, the other practitioners that you're working with. This is going to be a multi-part conversation. We are going to dive deeper into this with some examples, getting more specific about actual treatments and patients. Examples I'd like to use myself, toss it in there because who knows what's going on in this mess. You've been fortunate, or I've been fortunate enough to have you do a couple of sessions on me, and I've just been blown away. And it has nothing to do with the fact that I walk in the woo. It has all to do with the empirical data, the actual information that exists, and being able to look at it objectively, neutrally, so that you can say, is this something that is different than what I knew before and I should know more about?
We have to look at the energy that comes off. So whether you call an energy an organ, I'll just use this quickly here, but there's just the plate. And then let's say if I add a crystal or a water, you can actually see the difference in the blood immediately. And you can do it through sound, but in here, what you're going to do is you're going to start emitting sound or vibrations, just like an ultrasound, just like they're using direct energy weapons and HARP. So when I go to place the water, it is picking up that same energy vibration or oscillation. So then within minutes, it starts again resonating with it. And you can actually taste the water difference. I love doing that with all my clients. So again, we have them. And then what happens is when you taste it, it's slicker, it's lighter, and it's got a silky thing. So one of the things as well, like I said, I could put the crystal on too. Okay, so I can also send what's I can send a soundtrack to someone, right? So it's more important to do some of these things like live, but in here as well, it's again from seeing all these people that are really ill. We're starting to see a lot of people that have got really, they're dark brown, dark black. The aura fields have totally been changed. You can start seeing people, this would be kind of like, I wouldn't say bipolar, but you can see when there's things not integrating or someone that's being, they're trying to transgender. Okay? You can see what's starting to come off these people or if there's blockages in like the liver gallbladder meridian on this side or in the spleen, in the stomach. Just like iridology, you could see that. And we can feel those vibes. There are some people that, I mean, are just totally like grayed out. You know, there's some of this stuff like so brown and stuff like you just can't believe it. And those are the people that are like loose harvesting, or you go into a room and they go, you feel like, oh my God, I think they're draining me. I just can't handle. Like there are people like, you know, and again, may not be, you know, total and humane, but once we start getting into this, now, like I was showing you, Lorraine and I were doing a lot of stuff there, and we've been working our little butts off here for a couple years, but we can back it up. It's scientific. And if you go into Russia, right, this is what they do.
Yeah.
The top Russian doctors have their scanners. I've been in stuff that looks like Area 51 with some of the top Russian doctors. They scan you. They got more. Like I said, it looks like you're going into a cockpit, but again, it's all done through frequency. And you look at the regen beds, and the problem being is that you're seeing a lot of people too, that they're making like cute little pods. They got some hyperbarics, but I looked at this stuff. I looked at one of the ones they were making, and you know what he does? He's got the old biofeedback, the big one. Oh, well, we're scanning you and it's monitoring you. I said, yeah, and this one's like $30,000 less. I have that tech, but again, to me, a lot of that tech is 20, 30 years out of date already. And this one you keep adding to. I mean, I go outside and I make a tincture. I can make you a bliss ball. I could make you a shake, one of my famous shakes. And then it is famous, by the way. Actually, I'm a famous chef. Ask any of them. Okay, so, but I could make a shake up here and put all those frequencies in here, or a lot of times, like the phytoberry shakes and stuff. So these are just a few of the favorite things, but this is where medicine's going, and it's combining what you said. And again, do I look at this as, this is made out of minerals, out of the earth.
Yeah.
They've mined it. They've wrecked our stuff. There's gold, there's silver, there's all sorts of things in mother lodes in here. But again, you have to use it with some discernment. And we have free teaching. I'm one of them. There's Dr. Debbie Drake teaches one day, and we've got Denise, and then I'm every second day. And one of the things too, I'll just show people because I'm gonna see if I could share because I'm just excited to do this now. I'm in a mood. Okay, so in here, let's just see if I was looking for results or something. You wanted to go look at some of this technology. You could just go into Rumble and actually put in Karen Macdonald, and you'll see all the different things that I have done. By the way, typical skeptic is where Robert and I met. But anyway, okay, I just did a great one in here at the Grassroots Network with Carol Maureen Friesen. Okay, a lot of stuff that is in here that you can start going into, like the basis project and stuff. And then one of the things I wanted to also go into is when you start looking at where we do the teaching, a lot of what I talk about is not YouTube friendly, obviously.
Imagine
Okay.
that.
Imagine that. Anyway, but I do have my own. But if you're looking for some of the stuff that I did do, that if any of this resonates, you can go into BitChute and just actually type in Clan Mother. We'll get you this one. I just want to see what came up. Or Karen Macdonald or Karen Lucic Macdonald. But this is where I teach with Quantum Chit Chat every second Sunday. So I was talking about spiritual warfare. We were talking about the stuff coming up with the ellipse, getting back to getting community, electronic warfare, parasite cleansing, how to do the. I did a whole thing on yoni steams and smoke and smudging and lingams and that sort of thing for the guy's hair. And then this is where I taught a lot of usages, bloodlines, power items, ancestral meditations, working with some of the different people in here. I did a whole thing on what life blood is. And all of these are how we use the genius or how can I enhance with what I'm doing. I did a whole thing on water alone. And then the biofield, what's disharmonic, crop circles I've done, Pascal's in here. And then the people that wanted to know about the clan mother governance, it's in here, protecting your DNA. Dr. Dina Churchill. So, like I said, there's a variety of stuff out there when you start looking. And I've done a lot with a lot of people over the years, but it comes down to what are you doing to make a difference? And that's when it came back to about loving ourselves. And if you take the chart, love is very mediocre, quite frankly. It is. When people say, oh, I love you. Oh, you got to love yourself. No, I want to get into co-creation with the creator.
Well, and the part of the problem too, going back to some of the other subject that we talked about, is that that word has been mangled and manipulated. There's what, 30 or 40 different versions or definitions of love, depending on what it
Yeah,
is that you're
exactly.
expressing,
And
right?
yeah, it's like snow up here.
Yeah.
Two or three
You
ways.
know, one of the things in closing here, because we've been going for just over 2 hours, so this is going to be a lot for everybody to absorb, and we're going to have, it seems to me, at least three or four more follow-ups on this, because it's just we're just scratching the surface. But in the geezer geek in me, the original Star Trek boy from I watched the very first episode when it came out on a nice black and white, I think it was a RCA. And I became a Trekkie from that moment on. And one of the things that, there's two things that I keep telling people, especially the ones that go on about being all afraid of this AI shit. Because I'm a geek and a geezer and I've built technology for over 40 years, I know that none of the stuff that people are talking about being fearful of it, most of it as far as the robots taking over and taking our lives and eating us and all that stuff, that's just not going to happen. No. It has the capability to do a lot of damage, but more importantly, it has a lot of capability to do a lot of good. And when people talk about, you know, Ray Kurzweil was recently on Joe Rogan, and it was one of the most pathetic things that I'd seen in a long time. And Ray is the guy who's, you know, promoting the whole transhumanism and the singularity and all of that. Yeah. But when people say, well, I'm scared of tech, I'm scared of the AI, I'm scared of the robots, it's like, go watch a couple episodes of Star Trek, okay?
You put your light switch on and you're even on a computer, which is making you more. And I had to deal with that. I had a client in the UK yesterday I was dealing with, absolutely paranoid because of the V2K. But this is some serious stuff. I mean, we're hearing people that are, I mean, they're getting beam stuff. They're picking up stuff that they shouldn't be. And I said, you know what? It's this voice to skull. It's also no different than basically in a simple sense of a radio station that's beaming all the time. Right. I don't want to listen to the country music. I don't want to listen to the maybe blues or something that day. But again, I don't want to listen to what they're beaming either. So there are ways that we can use these kind of technologies to do that. So when someone comes near me, basically when I have an aura and I'm actually on my game on there and I got a really nice hot pink, purple aura, something like that, you know, ain't gonna be too much, even a chemtrail coming in that's not gonna get burnt up on reentry. Or like I said, even today, just like with the aura that I just did of myself, right, while we were talking. I mean, I gotta be happy with that. That's beyond indigo. That's getting into the white, you're getting into the turquoise, into the higher things other than this purple. So that's what someone, when they talk about get high vibe, how are you gonna get that and how are you gonna assess that? To me, this is no different than a mood ring, you know, and.
Well, it's even deeper and more richer than a mood ring. And where I was going with the Star Trek analogy with technology.
Yeah.
That Genius app is essentially a tricorder.
Welcome to our world.
Right.
Okay, so then I'll just give you a little hint what we're doing. So then I can take things that they gave me to experiment, and then you hook them up with this. Remember the corded app. Mm-hmm. And then start thinking about what I can do with an array and geodes and crystals, right? Or I could stand on it and then make myself the antenna, okay? The whole key about doing this in self-sustainability is this is not new technology. If you look on the pyramids, and I can show it to you, you can look on the pyramids and you can look where they got the cell phones and this kind of technology. It's not new. And this is an extension. If you were in Russia, this would be the Department of Radiology. Their biofeedback specialists and technicians and colon hydrotherapists are in the same place where they're doing x-rays, MRIs, and all sorts of other things. And I'm all about doing integrative medicine, but in a holistic way that is not going to be detrimental to the client. You know, so if we can find a much better way, I'm all for it. And I'm really, like, I've been experimenting with so many things over the years, right? And, you know, I just had a come to moment when I met, again, Dr. Dina Churchill's one of our therapists as well, as I mentioned, and so is Dr. Debbie Drake. And I really encourage people to look at some of her work we did on YouTube. She just did on LED. We've got some new stuff that's coming out. You've heard about the LED pulsing and stuff, and I don't mean LED in a bad sense. It just means light emitting diode, but we can actually take the sound in here and I can interface it. So now I can convert the sound from in here into a light. And right now we are measuring what's called the nitric oxide, or like similar, a little different than oxygen, but the ability to carry that with the NO, and it's increasing the nitric oxide by up to 700%. So you get a lot of people that are having problems breathing right now because of the clogging, and I'll just say for what's inside, you know, if we're died suddenly, right? semi-synthetic. So these are natural ways. And so, like I said, if you don't want to go to the hospital and you don't want to do ivermectin, it will show you the wormwood, the black cohosh, the cedarwood essential oil. It will tell you the oak, whatever you want, essence. It will match that up. And then you can give it by sound. And if you don't want to be hooked up, hook up your water glass and then drink the water. Like I said, there are people for different levels, different knowledge. And that's what I'm saying. This is a time to be very, very excited in here. And I'm very blessed to have had and been mentored with some of the top people and quantum physicists in the world and been able to bounce things off people. And I'm very grateful for this opportunity. And I think what you're doing is absolutely marvelous. You know, I'm definitely in your cheering section, as you know, and I'm putting it up all over my social media because you don't realize the connections right now that we're at the forefront of creating these new visions. We're not going back and taking the old roots and going back to caveman days. We're actually taking what we've got and moving it forward. And it's the same thing that you're learning in law. This law that I'm telling you about, this law has always been there. I'm just going to take it and move it forward. It's my choice to do that. And that's the thing is that, you know, like I said, they're recognizing that, you know, and it's nice to see people wanting to come back to it. And I
And
don't want the Wonder Bread days and the Kit Kat days when I can have raw cacao, you know, and make like sprouted stuff. I mean, that's just like, you know, do I want Dairy Queen or do I want to get a Vitamix out in a NutriBullet and pull it from the garden, right?
wait a minute, so you're telling me the Cocoa Puffs and Captain Crunch that I loved in my youth is something that I should probably not love anymore, which I don't.
Well, you know, when I can take that, and you know, I will tell everyone if they go to actually Marcus Rothkranz and they download that free book, there's a raw chocolate book in there. It's absolutely amazing that you guys will love and thank me for whatever. There it is. There's the two books here on here. This book, if you go to Marcus Rothkranz, you can download this entire book for free. And there's a chocolate thing that will replace your Cocoa Puffs. But I also make it too, and I add essential oils. But again, people don't realize, you know, they think we're talking about face and beauty, we're talking about acupuncture, or, you know, getting into the very simple thing of what PMF is, right? This is the energy. We're connected to everything. And what we're doing is just a pulsed, energetic, electrical, magnetic field. And we need to kick it back because most people are about that big right now. You know, and you've got to be able to come above and below, come back down. It's like the eagle and the condor come back in and go, oh. You know, then you get to have fun. You know, so
Well,
I hope this has been helpful.
speaking of fun, I mean, we
Want to
could go
have
on for another couple of hours here, but I'll
Sure.
keep this semi-digestible because you covered an amazing amount of just incredible eclectic things across the board. We touched on, well, we got deep into the ancient technologies and traditions of healing. And then we've spent the last more than an hour or so going over this, using those techniques and technologies or the traditions and the frequencies and using today's technology to bring them forward in a way that is
Yeah.
just genius.
And I'm happy to say I helped create and co-create a lot of it. A
It
lot of
just
it is actually the stuff I've been doing. But like I said, it's having the people that have ethics and integrity, right? Like, you know, I can call up Ryan and say, Ryan, can we look at this? Or, you know, that type of idea. And the stuff that I've seen people coming through and the miracles I've seen, there's one that's actually on there by Christy Miller. And I had a guy that literally was paralyzed again, like Dr. Anderson and other people, in their beds. And I come in, I do that my little holistic quantum little nurse thing and play, you know, thank gosh, not Nightingale, Florence, but you know, go in there or I did stuff with Pascal. Okay, this I can talk about it because that's out there, you know. But then a lot of times they'll go do stuff, and now, like I said, the concern is a lot of the stuff that people are bringing out at this nanotech that, like I said, it's not quite proven here yet. And as they move up, the higher the frequency, when they move 5G, yeah, whatever, 6G, 7G, 8G, the higher you are, try and burst my bubble. I dare
Right.
you.
Well, that's the one thing that we know, one of the many things, but in this part of this great reveal is those who have been given the authority, for whatever reason, have the supposed credibility to credentialize and authorize whatever the hell it is. All those folks have just completely blown any credibility they had. So now there's even more people that are at least aware that there is something else out there that they need to go find, they need to explore. And this, the conversation and what we talked about today, is hopefully going to be a gateway for a lot of these people that need to, they're on that path of exploration. They want to discover that which they thought they knew, but really didn't. And the vast realm of just fundamental knowledge and the way of the frequency fields forever, because that's what we're seeing. That's what we actually live in, and that's what we are going to see unfold in the future. So, Karen, I cannot thank you enough for this conversation today.
Placebo. Trois aussi.
It has been just a joy and very enlightening. And we're going to have several more of these because there's just, like I said, we scratched the surface.
Hey,
And
you.
so I'm
I'll
looking.
teach you later what I'm actually saying. You means I love you too. Okay.
Thank you very much, Karen, for today. It's been awesome and a pleasure and an honor. Thank you.
Thank you.